Oh, hey guys, you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
I think we're on now, so the people on the internet should be hearing us as well. My name's Phil Kohler.
Hey.
Gosh, it's one of those nights. I'm being joined by Austin.
How's it going, guys?
Oof.
Yeah.
Janine.
How's it going?
Ugh. And Keith.
Hey. Yeah.
I'm sorry we're running late, guys. I just I've had a rough week. I haven't been getting any sleep. Have you
Yeah,
guys?
I know. No, it's been rough. I don't, at first I thought it was like I was just a busy week in general, but then I was off today, so I figured like, oh, I'd get
Yeah.
a lot of sleep last night. I just couldn't.
The weird thing for me is it's just been and I've never had this problem, but just nightmares. I just keep
I honestly haven't been even sleeping long enough to have a nightmare.
I've actually
Really?
been sleeping really well, except I like wake up in places I don't remember falling asleep.
That's strange.
Can I ask you guys a weird question?
Yeah.
Kind of personal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Does anybody get like patches of red skin?
It's like a rash, but
Yeah.
it looks
It's
like
like a rash, but like scaly.
the thing that's weird about it is it looks like someone was feeding.
We
It
knew
is kind of
Sammy. I
bites.
haven't
Yeah.
been
I
noticing
think
any rashes, but sometimes I wake up and my mouth tastes like someone else's rash skin. Keith.
Delicious rash skin. Great.
I just
How that
laughed
sleep
because
thing
that's
go?
just like a huge memory from my childhood of rash skin.
Someone chewing on your rash skin?
Yeah, it's like really nostalgic for me.
Yep.
American public
Well,
schools.
It's like if someone brought up Double Dare.
chewing on rash skin.
Yeah, it's like my Double Dare.
Of course it
Mark
is.
Summers. I see the crossover there.
All right, I'm gonna actually go into this game. I need to. Oh my
What
god,
is
what is
this
going
game?
on?
Also, what's this thing on the screen right now?
Hold on. We actually got fan art for this,
I see.
from two different sources, whose names I didn't write down because I'm literally the actual worst.
I think one of them was Satan, and the other was Molag Bal.
Sure. Yeah, that sounds right. They're
No,
probably
he's
in
an
the chat
artist,
room,
Molag
yelling right now. So,
Bal.
all right, let's actually do this. I need to share screens with you guys
Oh, right, that's
so
how
that you
this
can
works. I
actually
forgot.
see this. But we're started. Here's Recovery Search and Rescue Simulation. Here we go again.
You just turned into like a weird robot in your voice when you said that.
Yeah, that was on
It was like a
purpose.
transformation.
Later,
That was on
we'll have to
purpose.
slow down the stream and hear what was said in the crackle, like in between the sounds he made.
Difficulty medium. Perfect. Anthony says, forget the game. Do this forever. I think he just wants us to talk about our weird rash skin. All right, so we're on mission 12, time trial. Let's start it up. We're at night, so that's terrifying.
This
Ranger,
is new. We've never been at night.
I've been thinking as a park ranger, it's important that you're in peak physical condition. The terrain and the wages are tough, so you've got to be able to handle it, which is why I've come up with a little test for you. Jesus. A friend of mine has his own plane and has very kindly offered to drop items in the park. And what I want for you is to go collect them. Simple. The catch, they're all over the park, and I'm setting you a time limit. Like, every mission has had a time limit so far, but okay. Succeed, and you can have the weekend off. Fail, and you're on dead animal cleanup for a week. How many
That has
dead
a special
animals are there?
meaning
Like,
here.
this is like a. Okay, here's my question, bosses. Like.
Sacrifice cleanup duty.
I get why cleaning up the dead animals is important. Why are there so many everywhere?
And why have they all died in the same way?
Yeah.
And why do none of them have skin?
And how come there's literally a calling card next to them?
That's really the most confusing part.
To be fair, though, it's all about how you understand the word animal. People is a kind of animal. Plenty of them around.
That's why all the dead animals have human faces attached on.
Leaving flying
The craft
discs and
crew.
alligators. Crocodile, sorry.
Flying discs. Fuck. Oh, I forgot about the flying discs.
You can't call them frisbees. Frisbee is a it's copyright.
Is that for real?
Yes.
I
I
don't know.
Frisbee
I
brand flying discs.
promise. Is it called Frisbee brand flying disc? Is that true?
I don't think it's. I don't think it's a thing that you could get sued over, though. Like saying fly, like, oh, you said Frisbee in our game, in your game, you're sued.
Anthony Garbodi says, standard ranger test. Go into the dark heart of the forest and find the source of the mysterious moaning.
Mm-hmm. That's correct.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, what is your mission? It's like a...
There's a guy dropped stuff all over, like, from a plane, and I need to go find all the stuff before the time limit runs out.
It's a good use of ranger resources here. Mm-hmm.
Why don't they just drop it closer?
Yeah.
He's got the plane.
How do you not even have a light
on
your bike?
It's a test, okay?
Biking in the forest at night is so dangerous.
Mm-hmm. I just keep running into trees, and I'm fine.
I love
fine,
how much you can turn the handle without anything happening to the direction of the bike.
Yeah, I'm not... So that's just what it does when I'm just moving. Like, not even moving the mouse, just pressing forward.
That's just realistic. That's just, you know...
It's just always doing that.
That's speed, how the pros do
speed
it.
Speed terrain.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, God. It's at the fort.
Talk to anyone from
the
Port of France.
I told you I don't like going here. It's creepy, and at night, like
the fort is really.
The fort is probably my favorite feature of this. Mm-hmm. That light is
so
always
big.
On. Too.
Everything else is so small, but the fort is so big.
How do I get off the
bike? Monument is big too.
I don't remember how to get off.
Yeah,
the
but
bike.
there's no sense of scale with the monument. Like here, you walk up to a door, and you're like, you know, Jack and the Beanstalk sized.
God, we have so far to go. Oh, time did go up, so that's good.
Uh-huh.
They give us more time.
Like a checkpoint.
Yeah, it's a checkpoint.
No one said the Chief Ranger wasn't fair.
Or fun. He really likes...
He loves fun. He loves dancing.
He has a weird... Well, he
disfigurement.
He loves dancing if you have ankles. If
right.
you don't
otherwise,
have ankles...
not allowed.
It's crazy, like... the perfect storm of accidents that made this game.
God,
I don't
really
think anything about this is accidental.
Really?
I thought it was at first, but I just don't know anymore.
I hope it's not, because there's nothing more interesting to me than someone who made the, like, who spent hours and hours and so much of their time making this thing disguised as a piece of shit, but is mm-hmm. actually like a hidden masterpiece, prank, joke. Work of Satan or whatever.
The
like
creepy, the secret creepiest game ever.
Yeah.
If
and
it was
like,
on
got
purpose,
it published
it's the...
through traditional simulator brand like publishers and all
I'm
that.
Sure I'm sure a big part of it is someone like people who want to make games.
Uh-huh.
Some of them end up making simulator games that are boring.
Right.
And you know, maybe they want more. Out of what they're doing, and that's really what I think happened here is someone who wishes they were doing something else ended up with Recovery Search and Rescue Simulation. They ended up, I bet like it was just you know a writer or someone.
Right, well, that's the
someone
thing
who's just or even just contracted for like
right.
you know.
We've been talking as if this has been one person who made this game, but chances are it was probably a handful of people. And then
look at the credits.
Translated, right?
But also the other thing is what. I bet all of these levels were made and then the writing was made to
right.
fit the levels.
Yeah, exactly.
Just like,
right.
in this level, you're finding a backpack.
Right.
So,
that's what I'm saying.
And
like,
how many times can you say, hey, go find that backpack? So, you know, the writer did what writers do and went fucking insane.
Or, again, it could have been five writers and that's why some
boy.
Of these levels are super...
Well,
yeah.
Here we go. Here we
crocodiles
go.
Crocodiles falling from the sky. Whatever next? TikTok Ranger. Best head west now. He's like a Batman villain suddenly.
Yeah, he is.
He's a Batman villain, but he's on your side.
Yeah,
like he's ribbing you, but like at some point he's gonna like fucking rib you like with a knife.
You and I are the same, Ranger. Deep down,
no, we're not.
Yeah,
I'll never be like you.
But yeah, the other thing is a lot of these sim games come out of Germany, which means the original, I'm not sure if this one did or not, but if it did, that means that a translator had their hands in this too
mm-hmm.
and could have completely
yeah.
transformed the work.
Yeah.
It's, because it's...
The work.
It,
you know.
I guess it's... I guess it all depends on how many people actually made it. Like, I'm...
Right. Can I...
and where it's from, because there are a lot of you know, if we're talking like German sim games and stuff, a lot of Germans speak really good.
Are sinister?
No, like they're wow. English.
Whoa,
I'm half German, Keith. Jeez.
There's parts of me that's German. I'm just kidding.
Which parts?
My great grandmother was German.
Oh, I thought you meant like specific body parts.
Oh yeah, and like my ring finger.
Okay. Can I ask you guys a question? And I just want to clarify, you know, just in case anybody from the court is listening, that this is just the hypothetical. This is 100% a hypothetical question. Do you think a video game, you know, such as the one we're playing, could hypnotize you into killing someone?
So what you're really asking is, like, would a good defense, for instance,
well,
in a court case be?
I mean,
as an example, do you think a video game could get into your subconscious and convince you to sacrifice another human's life?
Okay, Phil, can I get real with you for a second?
Yeah.
Based on my last week, I goddamn hope so.
Oh god, that's a snake! That's a fucking snake!
Oh,
ah! Oh,
finally.
I think it bit me.
Oh, no.
I'll run it over. That. Fuck you, snake!
Snake repellent.
I ran him over.
Yeah, I don't know if that would work.
Snake repellent.
I don't know if running him over actually did anything or not. Oh.
So, Phil, how did your sleep study go this week?
Did they notice
anything out of... Okay.
I appreciate my friend helping me with this challenge, but chucking a parachute out of his plane might be a tad impulsive. Best stop worrying about him, Ranger, and worry about finding the next item. Head north. Great. His friend is dead.
Yes, that's correct.
I'm glad that they went out of their way to really make sure we knew that. My sleep study went okay. I keep hearing whispers. Do you guys hear those? Are you hearing that?
I don't. What are they saying?
The snake.
What sort of whispers?
They're usually commands.
The snake is your kin.
Is there like a pattern to what they're saying? I don't. What sort of whispers?
A lot of it is like I can't quite understand it. It's like a language I've never heard, but somehow it feels like in my soul, like I know it.
In your soul, does the voice talk about your soul a lot, Phil?
Do you think a video game could convince you to, like a ritualistic sacrifice, that kind of thing? You know, not like a regular everyday murder.
Like are you different... saying, like, subliminally convince you, or just be really, really persuasive?
Either or.
Yes to the former, super yes to the latter.
Oh, a super yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Double plus yes.
I definitely think that it would just take like a really good talker to convince me of something like that.
Yeah, honestly, to be honest, it doesn't take a lot to convince me of anything.
Right.
It's pretty easy. As Austin and Jean can attest from when they convinced me to play this fucking game.
That was really easy, wasn't it?
Yeah.
did all it take really was hard. One thing?
Yeah, it did. But the thing that I'm just realizing now is I remember you telling me yes to linking or to playing this. I don't remember linking it to you, and I don't remember where I got the link to this game.
I'm pretty sure this game made itself.
It was just an email in your inbox with like just no idea who it's from or how it got there.
This isn't a bit. I literally don't remember like when you were like, oh, we should play some dumb game, I was like, okay, this is the thing I should send him. I don't remember having seen this game before that, before me sending it to you. I don't know how knowledge of this thing got into my brain.
Just copied itself to your clipboard.
Right, my hand just went to Control V, and this is what appeared.
Guys, I don't have any energy bars. I'm getting real slow.
I see that. The good news about
I think this is how I die.
Phil, you gotta keep stocked up on Nutrigrain. Everyone knows.
I like how this game lets you just skip any level. It's like it wants you to complete it. Like
it's like there's like something waiting for us.
Yeah.
What? No.
Oh no.
That's definitely on purpose.
That's floating rock. That's a good picnic spot. Don't eat under it though. Eat beside it.
The moon is right above it.
Also, the bottom's invisible, like rocks. That's just geology.
Non-Euclidean geology. That's a thing, right?
It should be. If it's not, it should be.
You know what premiered today? Related? Hannibal. Hannibal's back.
Wait, did it?
Hannibal's back.
I should watch Hannibal. Hannibal's a good show.
Ranger Popular comedian Hannibal Buress? What's going on? What is?
Yeah, Hannibal Buress.
I just keep looking at the moon.
It was a closet. Yeah, he premiered his new show.
Darth Cylon says, "Hey guys, has anyone ever heard the phrase no ankles, no dancing? I heard it being whispered from the walls earlier."
I'm not familiar.
And there was blood crawling down them?
Allie in the chat says, "So, this isn't a bit, but I just heard a noise that sounded kind of like my house is puking."
I also like Jay Bantha's, "Zalgo is watching Hannibal." Just keep going. We can make it. Oh, God. Slowing down. Real hungry. The mission's over! What? Oh, no. I died. How did I die?
You starved.
Oh, jeez. That's okay. Whatever. Well,
let's go to the deer stalker.
Deer stalker.
Ranger, speaking there's word Hannibal, that a hunter called Eric Dredd. Oh my God.
He's lurking in the
literally, literally.
He's a ruthless fiend.
This is just Hannibal season 2, the video game.
He was spotted near the old fort. Like, everything about this game screams that it was on purpose.
Literally every time that I start to think, like, oh no, it just must be, like, coincidence. Then we get something like...
It's a humor and timing.
Then we get somebody named Eric Dredd. Well, this time I am going to buy.
Oh, jeez.
I have to know if this game was on purpose.
How do you stumble into Eric Dredd?
But because like whoever made this game, he's writing from the perspective of a character who hates hunters and tourists and garbage.
Right.
So he's like, Eric Dredd, because hunters suck. But also, Eric Dredd, this game is from the depths of hell.
Again, maybe it's just a weird translation thing. Like, maybe Dredd in German is the... Just like, maybe Dredd is the German equivalent of, like, Smith.
Friar John suggests that it's the great-grandsire of the famous Judge Dredd.
Like that Austin's... No, I like Austin's theory of just horrible-sounding things are super mundane in the German language.
Yeah, listen, nice.
Dredd is Smith.
Blazing Raven says, Eric Dredd, which I guess is I think his insinuation there is that Andrew Lee Swan, Dredd, is the evil hunter in this game.
Probably. I would buy it.
There's something evil in this game, but it's not the hunter.
Some people have called it a hunter. Is this a... Holy shit, I don't think we've ever seen this. Is this just like a...
Tar pit? Oh, they mentioned tar pits at the very beginning.
Did they?
Yeah, they did. He like there was one line that was like predators and cliffs and tar pits, and those are only some of the dangers. It was like one of the first lines.
Yeah, what are you doing?
It's hurting me.
Yeah, that's like a portal.
No shit.
Just standing in this poison swamp in the middle of the park.
And you say you graduated Ranger School where?
He can't remember.
It's been so long.
He can't remember anything.
I haven't talked to my family.
I can't even remember their faces or if they've ever existed at all.
I really need to figure out how to get off my bike.
D, as someone mentioned, for disembark.
I like how you've got the name of the game is on the bike.
Whoa, what is this?
Oh, right, that's where you can call for a helicopter.
I've literally never seen this. I'm going to call a helicopter.
You can spend points to get a helicopter.
I could have sworn that there were like vehicles in this game that weren't a bike.
Might help you.
Yeah, we're like they could just give you an ATV at that point, right?
Cool. We could have been using this. That'll help if we go back, I guess. Okay, that did it. What was that? B. B for to board. Get off the bike.
Yeah.
B for bike.
Yeah.
B for Zalgo. It's all for Zalgo.
Yeah, it's all for...
Aha, Dread's sleeping bag. How do I know? Because it's dreadful. Yeah.
See, and then things like that happen.
Yeah, it like... They just pile on all this
guys,
speechness, and then it's the dumbest thing
in the world. He's been camping here in a non-camping area, that motherfucker. How dare he?
It says you've got to find him, but is the subtext you've got to find him and feed?
Yes. You've got to find him and take care of him. All right, these are not natural rocks.
I love the idea somebody that as soon as you're here. Hungry, your life force drains from you in minutes.
In most places, that wouldn't happen, but here at the park, I don't know. Some strange
really
force.
To keep your strength up to fight those demons inside of you.
Something here just makes the soul weary.
I'm just going to ride this bunny.
That bunny is so small.
I know.
The scale of this game is so fucked up. I know that's like the least of things to be like, oh, that's weird.
The boars are like boar-sized, but then the deers are also boar-sized.
And the forts are like giant-sized.
Yeah.
And then the old gods are like as big as the map.
Right.
Something here. I can feel it.
I like how that grass is magically growing straight up out of solid rock. Was there a watermark on that rock texture?
It kind of looked like it.
No, there were actually.
What was there on the rock texture?
It was like a URL or something.
Oh my god, there totally is! There totally is!
What's the URL?
Fraser.com? Oh, Fraser.com. What's Fraser.com?
I assume it's related to the hit NBC sitcom Fraser.
Guys, it doesn't exist.
What?
Do you think that it was just the wrong URL?
No.
There's this URL in the texture. Dread's footprints. He must have been on the trail of a poor innocent deer.
It looks like R-A-S-L-E-R, Razzler.
Maybe.
I'm trying to find it again now. Oh, here it is.
That's not a thing either.
Someone take a screenshot and then enhance it using your CSI technology.
Raster? Rassle?
If only they were as
Raster, maybe.
If only they were as clear as those footprints.
Trassler? Or no, because it's www and then period. And then, yeah.
I need to translate Razzler. This page.
A Razzle?
Anthony Carboni says, the first of Zalgo's acolytes will bear the name of Dread. You will know him because he dares to camp where no man can camp.
Raster.com is a...
Oh, raster, like rasterizing.
I thought, but it's just this weird German company.
Oh, God.
It's just, welcome to the website of Grid Industrial Automation. I don't know what they do. They seem to have their hands in everything.
I like where this is going. This is a wallet. Look at all that money.
That's a lot. That's a lot of twos and ones.
This guy sucks. This guy sucks. He just dropped all his shit.
Yeah, he's the worst hunter.
Yeah,
ever.
Like. I realize keeping your shit on you isn't necessary to hunting, but it seems like.
Well, no, because you gotta have your wallet with a lot of cash in it, because you gotta bribe the morally weak deer into revealing the locations of their stronger companions.
By the way, this is like the worst place to hunt, because it's gigantic, there's no landmarks, there's very few animals, and all the meat is tainted.
By evil.
Yes. Yeah, it's tainted by dark magic.
I mean, maybe there's just nowhere else.
Don't do that.
Maybe, like,
I mean,
the
unless
rest
he wants
of the world
to...
has been completely destroyed, and Zalgo's actually protecting this one final sanctuary of life.
Or maybe the hunter just needs the tainted meat for a brew of some kind.
I'm trying to find...
What if Zalgo's the lesser of evils in the world?
What? What if that's the twist ending?
First, they'd have to introduce Zalgo.
I'm pretty sure... They already have. Also, we still have like 40 missions left. This game's not.
Oh man,
not nearly done.
Well, there's like there's 80 missions, right, or 70 something?
40,
yeah.
And you finished the first half in the first one.
This is mission 14. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Then never mind.
We're not.
I thought that you had done like 40, and there were 40 left.
Oh no, we did not do anywhere near 40. Also, we didn't complete some of the ones we did. Mm-hmm. What? Where?
Well, it's because they're garbage. They're terrible.
Yeah, that's true.
The missions are not why this game is the best game. So, what are you trying to accomplish?
Who can say? We're finding Dread. Oh, yep.
I totally forgot about Dread.
Defenseless with a C. Interesting.
That is interesting. Allie wants to know if you got the DLC. I think we're probably saving that.
Yeah, I don't have it yet, okay. But I certainly, at this point, I'm pretty committed. By which I mean I will not be able to sleep until we're done with this because the voices won't let me.
What is that weird spot of light?
Is that a body? Is there a body over here? Do you think it is?
Well,
Dread, no! You look just like all the other people.
look at his
on that. Are their hands always that blue, or does he have like a specially blue hand?
Oh, he has a specially blue hand.
He's married, though.
Maybe he's dead.
Can we go back to his hands again? Go back to his hands again.
Yeah.
They look scaly to me.
A little bit.
They do, yeah.
A little moist and sharp.
Eric Dredd, blimey, I guess those poor defenseless deer aren't so defenseless after all. He's positively black and blue. That'll teach him. The deer beat him up?
Also, so his slightly bluish hand is meant to be, like, bruising from a deer fight?
Oh, God. Oh, this is... Ranger, have you ever listened to the trees? Wait. No, I don't mean gossip with them. I meant, have you listened to their song? The music of this beautiful yet deadly world we live in? No? Philistine. Anyway, we let a local nature group, in quotes, group called Earth, Wind, and Gaia hold a music event in the park the other day to promote oneness with the environment. They set up stations around the park and played music to reflect the nature around them for visitors. Think I'll stick to mosh pits and death metal, thank you very much.
Who is this person?
He says
he mentioned listening to death metal earlier.
He says, yes, I mosh. I'm an eclectic person. It seems, however, that some of the musicians left their MP3 players in the park. Hey, can't be one with nature without your MP3 player. What?
You have to let me read this next part.
Yeah, go on.
Now, I don't remember much of this music event. When I look back, it seems like one mighty tunnel of music needed by Mother Nature herself. An odyssey into the colors of my soul, if you will. But I do remember the first music station was near the Cannon Monument. I actually quite liked the music. Lots of explosions, cannon noises. I found it strangely relaxing. Reminded me of my past life. Start there and see if you can find the MP3 player.
So there was a music festival where everyone was listening to their own iPod?
The implication was that the MP3 players were from the people playing the music, but that doesn't make a lot of sense.
No.
Like the recreational ones.
I just assumed, have you guys heard of like silent concerts?
Yeah, that's a thing.
Yeah, I just assumed that it was like a super hippie version of that.
That's not a thing.
I don't know. Like what... What else could it be?
If a silent concert was ever going to be a thing, it would be a thing in a haunted park. So
yes.
Yeah, it's something that like a coven of witches might hold, a silent concert.
It's just a bunch of like ghost skeletons playing their own bones with like mallets.
A musical hat.
What? Oh, he's just making fun of you. Great.
I think it might have a music note on the front or something.
You have concert paraphernalia. That's the band's logo. It's a single musical note.
Get back here.
I've had a hard time copywriting it.
Yeah. All right. Enough of that.
Okay. You've had your fill?
Blazing Raven says, not haunted, inhabited.
It's an important distinction. It is. Subtle but important.
Haunted suggests something used to live here. Inhabited makes it very clear that it's still here and still very much alive.
The reflections in this game are the most insane thing in the world.
They turn with... they only update when you stop moving. That's how they work. Someone pointed out in chat last time.
Yeah. Okay. Which is really bizarre. Like you would think... I guess they probably have their own proprietary sim engine that this is based on.
We're hours into this game... And really, still, the searching and rescuing we're doing 95% of the time is inanimate objects.
Yeah.
Yeah, someone in the chat pointed out we've never seen a live human.
That's...
No, well, we've never seen a conscious human. They've all been... this game's...
Right.
They've been, moving slightly, but that's
about it. This game's refusal or inability to make an upright human really... adds to the creepiness of the whole thing.
And it also teases you so much with their presence. There's a big marathon today and there's so many people and they're getting trampled, but you only find the dead ones. Or
the dead ones. I don't remember the music. 5 minutes ago I was in that area and there was no one.
A forgotten tie.
A campsite you stumbled across.
I'm all for free love, Ranger, but well, I say free. Have you seen our entrance fees recently?
National parks.
What does any of that have to do with a tie?
I don't know.
Are ties a thing that... Is that related to free love?
That tufts of grass are like nature's doorknobs, and that was kind of on one. So it's... Whoa. Yeah? Kind of. Ew, is that just a pile of meat?
No, that's a campfire.
Oh,
says music is like fire in your veins.
Now we have some more Estus flasks, right?
I thought it was like a bloody pelt.
That is totally just the creepiest way to describe the what music is. It's blank is like fire in your veins.
They do say that a heart attack is like fire in your veins.
Do they say that?
I don't know, probably.
I think...
someone probably says that.
The Chief Ranger just probably has fire for veins.
Yes. So, oh no, what you're talking about is actual fire for veins. I'm not... Oh, is that it? God.
Yeah.
There's music! You can hear the music!
No, wait,
really?
I can't
hear the music. Only you can hear the music.
Is it whispering to you, Phil?
Nothing says nature like the rumble of... Wait, is that the babbling of a brook? The mellow splishing and splashing of waves?
Oh my god.
It's coming back to me now. There was a music station by the river. That's it. I kept needing to use the toilet. Check it out, Ranger. What?
Slash, check it out.
In the river, that's gross.
Wait, what? What's happening?
It didn't say, check it out, Ranger. It said... / check it out, Ranger. The game is...
Okay, guys, don't understand what's happening right now. So you picked up an MP3 player and you heard nature sounds. So there's...
What happened is you found the MP3 player and then Chief Ranger started remembering the festival and then he kept peeing in the river.
Oh, okay. I thought he was thinking of some sort of
disgusting
fucking...
disgusting freak. He's the park ranger. He shouldn't be peeing in the river.
That's accurate.
He also should not be sucking the life out of the innocents, but...
Where do you pee outside?
Chief Rangers have all sorts of privileges that you and I don't have, Keith. They pee where they want to pee.
That's what you get when you enter the 1% of Ranger teams.
Wait, did they not have porta-potties at that huge concert? Because that seems like a significant oversight.
Listen, there's a lot about this supposed concert that doesn't check out.
Yeah, and also there's a tiny deer right there. It's tiny.
Is this another fucking...
Seer asks,
yep.
How did he hear it? Hear the MP3 when it was just you near it? Good question.
Water music and crocodiles go hand in hand, man.
Water music.
Crocodiles.
I cannot believe how much they rely on that one asset.
Mm-hmm. Well, literally, like, every time they add a new asset, it's an event in the game. It's like a huge... That's why I was so shocked to see the snake.
Yeah, it's a set piece.
Yeah.
That's where their budget went. Was that snake moving earlier?
I think that, that was the first... Oh, no, I guess all the animals are animated and nothing else.
The people sort of sway back and forth on the ground.
Their hands, like, move, like, recently there was life there.
I would suggest that animated is a strong word for what the animals are doing in this game. They animate. I wouldn't say they're animated. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm. It's an important difference.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Or...
He's making fun of the fact that shoes keep showing up everywhere in the park. He's starting to make fun of the fact that they are reusing assets over and over.
I think the other thing you could do with animated there is, you know, animated can be it can take an indirect object, or it can take a direct object, which is something else animated.
Austin, I need you to read this.
Okay. What is this sound that seduces my ears so?
Seduces.
Could it be the call of the wind? The gentle caress of the air? Aha, I'm getting something, Ranger. There was a music station on the cliff top. That was it. The music transformed me into a majestic eagle, and I felt I could break the chains of the earth and touch the face of the sun. Deep.
Jesus.
Is it... I mean, it's definitely more plausible that he literally turned into an eagle, shattered the chains holding the Earth in its orbit, and touched the sun.
Yeah. Like
that definitely had. He's not being deep. He just did that.
Right.
Like, that makes way more sense.
The chains that he's talking about are the chains that were keeping the old ones asleep and imprisoned under the Earth.
Anthony confronting him and says, "Yep, that's my line. That was it.
We're beyond my ability now," he says.
Yep.
Lumberjack Bonanza just says, "Makes you think." Which I like.
It's literally making you think things.
This game.
Oh, boy. Allie in the chat says, "I feel my soul changing each time more of the story is unlocked."
Spooky Addict says, "I see no light now that the old ones have been released from the deep."
From capital T, capital D.
Yeah.
The deep.
So
you can go back into the mountains now?
It was like a cliff. Remember that cliff that we jumped off of last time? I think that's where we're headed.
I ever forget it.
I think that is where we're going to look right now.
I can't believe that you died from... I mean, I can believe it, because it's this game, but you died from starvation after, like, 5 minutes of being hungry, and you jumped off the cliff and were literally fine.
Well, I died a couple of moments after jumping off the cliff.
Yeah, once the shock that you survived set in.
Yeah, well, it took down all your hunger meter when you jumped off,
yeah.
And then there was nothing left to keep you alive. You had the spell of the energy bar had worn off.
Matt Mitchell in chat says 792 points, which I keep forgetting is a thing in this game.
The points. Are there achievements?
Oh, I wish. No Steam
so.
Trading cards.
No, I don't believe there's anything like that.
What if the pit? What if
achievement
the...
just for the very, very end of the game? Oh, if you finish the game with your soul intact, you get an achievement.
What if this trading cards were all like different eyes up on a dark background? Like nothing, just eyes.
I would like all the different monuments, I think, as emoticons. I think I could do some work with those.
That's not a bad idea.
What about all the severed fingers from a hand? A left hand?
My left specifically.
What if it was just ankles?
Because the left hand is magic. The evil hand.
What if it was colon, ankle, colon? And now we know where they went.
The Diary of Lilith Strawberry Sunbeam. All right. I think that's like a hippie joke. Like, what's the name of the kind of person who would be out at a weird nature concert?
Is that what that is?
I don't know.
I mean, he was out at a weird nature concert.
Yeah.
And he seemed to be having a fucking great time and was also high. Like,
He transformed into an eagle. I mean,
and he's condescending about the
he
other
He shed his human fuck. Form and took to the skies as a majestic bird.
Is he still there? Is that why we've never met him? And he can see everything?
He's watching us from above.
He's ascended?
If we look carefully, if we go to the monument and we take out our binoculars...
Well, there are all those birds near the monument.
Well, that's just a waste of a good rucksack. I'm all for giving up material goods, but come on, how can you carry your beef and mustard sandwiches without a rucksack?
rucksack!
Beef and mustard is really specific.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right, let's look at these bushes here.
I mean, everything that this game chooses to say is the worst way to say what it's trying to say.
Which is almost impressive.
Yeah,
in its
own
way.
They have not made a single... I mean, arguably every step they've made is the right step, but they haven't made a single actual right step in terms of real game making.
I mean, I think in a lot of ways, the writing is what makes this game way more interesting than, like, Warehouse and Logistics Simulator, even though the gameplay is kind of the same.
If that game had writing like this... I think like these already.
If you broke down these games based solely on like core mechanics and actions, they're the same.
Oh man, look at the way there's a sign and some trees over there, and when I look at it, it just looks.
No, that's an effigy.
I think it's a black portal into nothing, and those are the tendrils reaching in.
Yeah.
From the other side.
Yeah.
Tendrils are usually
sometimes
wiggly,
a sign.
Though.
It's a sign, guys.
They are wiggly if you. On their end.
I think it's an effigy.
It could be both.
It was just a sign and a tree.
Effigies are often connected directly to the open
world.
Oh,
it was a sign, all right.
Help me out.
You should radio in for a beef and mustard sandwich.
Give me a sandwich, please. What is in this music?
He's charging you to use the helicopter that is part of your job.
Whoa. What is in this music? I mean, look at these sketches. Now, I've seen the monuments in this park every day since I started working here, because he comes here every morning and worships at them. None of them swirl into vivid rainbow spirals whilst unicorn moths flutter in the sky. That is...
strange.
Man, look
Everyone
at that.
Knows the spirals are red.
I didn't realize this sketchbook thing is just... It's just the monument.
Mm-hmm.
That's
Where
terrifying.
Is he seeing rainbow sparkles and butterflies?
Who can say, you know?
You see a lot of things once you've transcended beyond the mortal plane.
Yeah. You can see, you know, when and when not to use the word whilst.
Just how intense did this music event get? Wait, is this why I can't remember much of it? That's a taser, so he's suggesting he got tasered.
There's a lot of stuff this guy can't remember.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, here it is. I hear the music.
He's a plane shifting bird.
That sound, that glorious guttural rumbling, the sweet smell of porridge in my nose. Hang on. Don't tell me those hippie music makers set up a station near the bear cave. Just who or what did I dance with?
Just who or what? Did I dance with?
I think he's implying a bear. Or a bear.
What? Or a bear god.
That's why he was smelling the porridge.
Mm-hmm.
It was just right.
Yeah, wait, what?
The guttural rumbling.
the bear guts the man just right porridge.
I wonder how Sophie's doing.
I miss Sophie.
She's always
Sophie
there.
Never was.
She never was and always will be.
That journal was just an imprint of what could have been.
How are you guys doing?
I feel sick.
Wait, really?
I feel like something's eating me from the inside.
Oh, that's just the flesh-eating virus.
Yeah, yeah.
So you're fine.
I like to think of it as a brain worm.
Mm-hmm. I mean, technically, that's what they call it, yeah?
Yeah, right. Yeah. It kind of, like, I feel... Does anyone feel like flaying the skin from their bones? Or from someone else's? It's not...
Usually someone else's, yeah.
Yeah.
I feel... I don't feel like flaying the skin from my bones. I feel that I've flayed the skin from my bones. I mean, that's... I thought we were all going to get prepped for tonight. I already did. I'm already...
I did ask you to do that and send me pictures.
Which I did.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I've been reduced to flayed skin.
Just the skin, though.
I'm a husk. Yeah, yeah. Right. Does anyone else feel occupied soul-wise?
Occupied soul-wise.
Hashtag occupied soul-wise.
That's going to be the name of my next Starbound character.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Mm-hmm.
Mike, check, there's a demon inside me.
Occupied soul-wise is the name of my new Christian rock band.
Oh. Is that your Zalgo rock band? No?
I'm just going to throw this out there. Not that different.
No, definitely not. I agree.
Really not that different. I feel like I'm walking with a limp. Look at this. It's just a weird, like...
I want to be clear. In my mind, Ranger Mike Danger has a limp. Yeah. So, he didn't always, but he got one suddenly, and he doesn't remember why or from what. But one day he
woke
up.
In my mind, Ranger Mike Danger's left leg is slowly petrifying and turning to fine, smooth marble covered in arcane carvings.
The weird thing is, it's the consistent, like the feel of it feels like bark, like tree bark.
It looks like marble though, still, yeah. But feels to the touch like tree bark. That's what has the doctor so confused.
Do you think that maybe because the Chief Ranger is slowly being eaten away, he's brought you here to complete some sort of transformation where he takes your body over? And you have to do all this in order to complete that? What? No?
There are always two. There's always the Chief Park Ranger and then his under whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Like the laws of the Sith is what you're saying?
Yeah, basically. Yeah,
This one is, that's going to be what we discover, like, as the game goes on, is that he's, the one that we're currently working with has been the Chief Ranger for, like, mm-hmm. thousands of years, because right. he's just kept successfully taking over the one below him. Mm-hmm. They've never caught on fast enough, but we're smarter than that. We caught on. Maybe we'll be
but
the
we're
ones
still
to survive.
Doing his bidding.
Only
how
so
do
far.
We break free from chains?
How do we turn into an eagle and break the chains?
And yeah. reach for the sun.
Blazing Raven says, seriously, these mountains are forming around us. What is happening? Lumberjack Bonanzas notes that Chief Rangers can shoot lightning from their hands.
True. And pee in the river. Those are the two things.
Yeah, those are their two powers.
Yeah.
I feel like Mike Danger's constantly aware, but still can't really see that he's trapped in the valley.
Right, right.
Like, when he looks at the mountains, everything just kind of gets a little fuzzy. You just smell the smell. Oh, the smell of porridge.
He can't remember, like, the last time he's seen... the outside world, but he still has his vague...
Spooky Addict says, have we always been this tall, or are we shrinking?
Yes, the answer is
he's
yes.
He's not limping, he's crawling.
Oh.
Anthony Carbone says, you caught on to his plan, but somehow you're unconcerned. You keep thinking you'll deal with it later, after one more errand.
Yeah.
Every time you think about it, you decide...
Is this like a wolf?
Don't... What is that?
I don't know, I couldn't tell. It looked like a wolf or a big raccoon. Like a really big raccoon.
It was probably a big raccoon. The scale in this game is a little weird.
It was a tanuki. Maybe you're in Japan? Where is this game? Where is this happening?
It's somewhere in the U.S. America? No, it's in the U.S. because they talk about the Civil War.
They do talk
about it. It's beneath the
lots
U.S.
Lots of places have had Civil Wars.
No, it's about... They talk about, like, the monuments say something about the North and the South and, like...
Lots of places have a north and south.
Yeah, literally all
really?
Places.
I'm pretty sure it's the U.S.
It's either
and or another above plane of existence.
Right, Arkansas. Right.
Our voyage into the musical heart of the park has reached its terminus, and now I understand all these claw marks on my back. Perhaps we'll make the nature music event an annual thing.
It's so like for real. This guy's saying that he got super high, was dancing with hippies. Then with a bear, and then got tased. And he woke up, couldn't remember the night before, except that there was a party, and all the scratch marks on his back, the gashes, the bleeding gashes that somehow give him strength.
Also, you finished that thing with 12 seconds to spare, so good job.
Oh, good. I didn't notice. Ranger, have you heard of the famous explorer Dakota James? What do you mean, no? Have you not seen her books in the shops? Or watch the movies they've made about her. She's been everywhere. Discovered the remains of lost civilizations. Survived the harshest conditions known to man. And battled with an immortal knight.
What?
You remember going to the movie theater as a kid and loving it. But you just can't. You don't know where the movie theater was. You think really hard about the last movie you saw. But you can just remember the mountains.
Oh my god, strange. You guys. She was heading towards the old mine to look for ancient artifacts. Artifacts with an E.
Oh, jeez.
This is...
Jeez.
Everything in this game.
What if it was like that connected AE? Like, that just means something weird and magical?
Everything in this game is pointing to evil.
Yeah. That's what the E stands for.
Good friend Ali says, this is only mission 15 of 47, and this dude already has mysterious claw marks. I'm freaking out.
Oh, so Phil, I was wondering this before. Is there any, like, noise in this game at all?
Not really. Not a lot. I mean, there was the noise when I heard...
Oh, the music from the iPod. But there's no music otherwise.
Hold on.
No, like, sound effects? Okay.
I think there's noise coming from the mine.
What sort of noise? What sort of...
Wait, did it say she was a pyromaniac?
No.
I couldn't read that. I was
no,
clicking
she was
really
a pyromancer.
Oh,
that's different.
Yeah.
That looks like Miss James' rucksack. Strange that it's not being worn by Miss James, mind you. Perhaps she went adventuring elsewhere.
Oh, another death?
Maybe she just left her rucksack and then walked outside and decided to go somewhere else.
Weird that they didn't decide to introduce a living person into the game.
I wonder if we'll find her passed out.
Or worse.
I wonder how many claw marks she'll have.
I wonder how scattered she'll be.
Do you really think a continent-hopping hero like Dakota James uses a handbag when she's in the field? She might be fabulous, but a true explorer values function over fashion every time. Try again, Ranger.
Yeah, but
this
also
is just
there's
an
someone
unrelated
lost their purse.
By the
just
mine.
Get this purse. Like,
it's a mine purse. They're naturally occurring.
Worst case scenario, there's a couple bucks in there.
It's like you've never even... It's like, you know, it's a gold. You know, it's a gold mine, and the gold's in little purses in the rocks.
This is a simulator, after all.
Seer says, why is that minecart 7 feet tall?
I keep secretly hoping that you're just going to find, like, a ripped Lara Croft model. Just
so she dropped her inhaler.
Uh-huh.
It's convenient she has an inhaler.
I wonder if she was fleeing something when she dropped it.
There's something in the air here
something
that makes
unspeakable.
People have trouble breathing. Breathing is like a syrup. It's disgusting.
I mean, some scientists came by and they called it a miasma, but I don't know.
I'm not sure what miasma means. One of those fancy science words.
We just call it the dark mist. It smells a bit like porridge.
I think miasma might be one of those fake science words, though.
People are linking to Zalgo.com. Like, is that an actual website?
It's like a plague.
It's for
thing.
Sale.
Oh, it's
for sale for like $5,100.
Yeah, I think it's a. I think it's like a homeopathy
like a bad
thing.
Air that gives that makes you sick, and they thought that was what caused the plague and stuff. So they'd
but no, but just because you're dirt balls, you old idiots.
Oh, here's something. Park Adventurer Monthly.
Ooh.
And it has our old gold mine is on the cover.
Oh, I really thought they said old.
The bears are back. 10 ways to survive a bear attack. There's gold in them, their hills.
Uh-huh.
Cover story, the old gold mine. The one.
That one. You know, the one.
I wanna, the old one. I'm trying to... Featuring something, all that... I don't know, whatever. I can't read it.
So, national parks.
Now there's a damn fine publication, if I do say so myself. Dakota James sure has good taste. I wonder if they printed my letter. Okay.
You didn't check when the issue first came out, you jerk.
I don't think they print things written in like runic scrawl because they don't have the font for it.
They definitely don't print things that they receive 3 times a day, every day for 5 years.
Written Dakota, in feces.
Dakota James would never litter in a place of, and I quote, outstanding natural beauty. I will not have her good name
quoting?
Trashed by you. I don't know.
Who's he quoting? What?
He's quoting himself. Two, is he saying that by looking at a soda can, you're trying to ruin the good name of a human being who probably has like littered at some point?
At some point in her life. Have you gone into the mine yet? Why haven't you gone into the mine?
I mean, you can't go very far in.
You can't
go in. Oh, right.
So like, I assume, you know, she's an adventurer. She would probably just jump over this and go like, she wants to get in here, right? But like...
But she's not there.
She's not here. She's gone.
Phil, I know it looks like you're there, but you're not even there.
She just disappeared.
What if your transformation is advancing and you're starting to see human bodies just as rocks?
Well, that's because life is inconsequential.
Right.
This world could be hidden. Like
hold on.
We're all just
human
minerals.
Life.
Right.
Isn't
your time scale has changed and you just see things as what they will eventually become anyway.
All right, I'm going to ask for help.
Every 1,000 years is a blink.
Asking for help doesn't help that much.
What's it give you?
It just it makes the circles that show where shit is smaller.
Okay, smaller. Okay.
Just get some more help. Can you only get help once?
Times? Yeah.
Yeah,
call
I don't
a
think,
cave helicopter.
I don't think it actually does anything when you do it a second time.
It looks like it got a little smaller.
Oh, I see prints.
Oh, nice.
I love that, like, he knows he has a better location of where it is than he gives you.
Mm-hmm.
And then he makes you ask him for
and
help
pay points.
Yeah, and you have to pay for it.
Although, you know, I gotta say,
you pay for it.
At my previous job, they paid me in money, not points. A camera. Have a look at the picture. Mist-shrouded ruins. Mysterious waterfall. Old and probably haunted cathedral. Yeti.
Yeti.
Yeah.
God.
I like that she's discovered the Yeti, but she's just sitting on it.
Yeti confirmed. And then she died in this mysterious cave.
She's just sitting on it until she explores this old fucking gold mine in California or wherever.
But she can't. She's putting it together. She's putting together the real...
Yep, there she is.
Got it. She looks real dead.
Famous explorer, dead of exposure on a sunny day.
Look at how pale her face is.
She could use a lot of lip chap.
She looks super dead. This is not good. Yeah. She's not moving. Like, there's no...
Looks like someone her bangs,
wait,
too.
You need... No, wait. Check her hand. Is her hand super blue? Because if so, we know the deer gangs did it.
It's pretty
good. No, I don't see a blue.
I think it's less kind blue, of blue because of her shirt. But
Miss James, you found her just in time, Ranger. Quickly, mm-hmm. Now call in a helicopter. I don't... Did we find her in time?
I don't know.
Here's Monster Hunter.
Great.
Ranger, hold on to your hat for this one. It could be the toughest challenge you face so far. I've been getting reports of a monster in the park.
Okay, here we go.
Yes, you heard me right the first time. An honest-to-goodness monster. According to witnesses, it's large and green and lurks in the river near the old broken bridge. Sometimes I wonder, Ranger, should we have built a national park here?
Fuck.
What? What ancient and slumbering beast have we disturbed? Perhaps a sacrifice will quell its rage. Ranger, you'll do. I mean, get out there and find it.
That is the greatest justification of all time. I feel totally...
This is so good, but I already know what it is.
Yeah, of course, it's the alligator.
It has to be.
There are no
other green assets in this game.
Jesus.
Oh, fuck.
They know! They know! The people who made this game know!
This is perfect. There's... I have to find the person that wrote this.
I know.
We need to get them onto the stream.
We need tonight, before we end, check the credits so we can spend a little while looking into it.
Oh my god. This is... Okay. Like, Spooky I'm so glad that they said that.
Spooky Addict says, I was joking before, but now I'm afraid.
Let's see here.
God, there's lots of ways that... Oh, man. Oh, this is so good.
It's so good, even though, again, we know it's just going to be a dumb alligator. Oh, is this what I'm looking for?
The thing is, they're building up enough, like, weird shit so that if it isn't...
Oh, what poor soul fell victim to the vicious beast? Can't our visitors fish in peace without fear of being mauled? We'll build a monument to the victims of the great national park monster.
A park needs more monuments.
A monument. Another monument.
Maybe that'll quell it.
Yeah, like, if it's... At some point, like, all it would have to be would be for this mission to end with, like, I guess we'll never know what that monster is, and there's no crocodile, and it would be the best mission of all time.
He just named the monster Alan.
With one L.
I've heard it.
Wait, what have you heard?
Is this a different
bike? Alan with one L? I've seen Alan with one L before.
Oh, yeah.
There, what's that? It's just a bike. I thought we had it then. I wish people wouldn't dump these things around here. If it's not shopping trolleys, it's bikes. Litter bugs.
Who abandons perfectly good bikes without being in serious danger? Wait,
who has a shopping cart here?
Yeah, I don't...
The closest shopping mall would be, like, a grocery store would be miles and miles and miles away. Who's like, well, you know it'll be a great prank? Let's drive 25 miles to the nearest national park and just throw a shopping trolley on the ground.
Dude, how do you think the bears get their porridge here? They gotta buy in bulk because they don't have that much disposable income. And then how are they gonna get it back here? Bears can't drive cars.
You know, you make a good point. Bears don't have a lot of disposable income. Bears can drive cars. It's just not very safe. It's
enviro bears can drive cars, but they're a very, very specific subset of the species.
And they're very specific cars that they could drive.
Yeah.
Hyundai's. Only Hyundai's.
Yep.
Enviro bears? Is that what...
Have you never played Enviro Bear?
No.
Jeez, I thought you were a professional game reviewer.
I haven't played Enviro Bear.
I've also, to be 100% clear... And this is something I've been meaning to talk about in a while for a while on the stream. I've actually literally never played a video game.
This is the first one.
I'm not playing this right now.
Oh, okay. That helps.
It's just happening in front of you like a player piano?
Mm-hmm. In a lot of ways, I feel like the game is playing me.
Did you get like a monkey's paw at one point and you were like... I wish to be a professional game reviewer, and then the finger folded down, and it was like, oh, you are, but you never actually get to play. They all just mysteriously complete themselves. Yeah. That's the catch.
This is the Twilight Zone episode of Phil Kohler's life.
Monkey paws, man.
Oh, Oh, that's a snake. Fuck you, snake. Running that snake over doesn't do anything.
You gotta get that snake poison or whatever, the snake mace.
Snake venom?
Snake mace.
I think that's what it was, wasn't it?
It was snake mace.
Was it?
Yeah.
It was definitely snake mace. Which, like, yo, the bear mace would work fine.
Yeah, probably.
Bears are bigger and have, like... Right. Yeah.
Help me.
I bet, like, snake mace is probably, like, stickier or something, because they don't have fur or something. I don't know. I'm sure there's some sort of formula difference that I have to justify it. Mm-hmm. Oh. Otherwise, they just call it animal blinding spray.
Boots, no doubt ripped from the feet of yet another one of Alan's victims. What sadness. What horror. And it's a joke about Alan.
Oh, wait, did he say Alan because he named the monster Alan?
Yeah.
Yeah. I think it's pronounced Alan.
Alan.
Also, I'm pretty sure.
A baseball cap. Does Alan's bloodlust know no end? Your loss shall not be in vain, dear entrance fee-paying visitor. Alan must be near, Ranger. Take care.
There's an apostrophe after the A that they couldn't render in this game, that's all.
I can see the fucking the crocodile from this far away.
So, but like, definitely for sure, since it's a crocodile, the fate of the owners of those clothes is unknown.
Right. Yeah. Right. That's like, the thing.
Those are just mysterious deaths now.
Yeah.
Alan, you foul fiend, prepare to... Oh, it's just an inflatable crocodile. Good thing I've still got the safety on this here shotgun of mine. That could have been embarrassing. And so the mystery of Alan is solved. Ugh.
Wait, where is he? Just a swimmer's
toy that got away.
He has a shotgun?
Yep.
He's in the air, floating above us. I'll have to return those I Survived a Visit to Alan's National Park t-shirts that I had made up. 2,000 of them. That's a lot of shirts, Ranger. Ugh.
Ugh. I think Keith's point stands, which is all of that shit about dead people is still there.
Yeah.
Yeah, like all those people still died. He just was making glib jokes about birthday cards.
There are a lot of known causes of death in this park. It's just the unknown causes of death that are a concern.
Ranger, I'm in a foul mood today. No, not because of football last night, though I'll add that to my list of things to rant about later. No, I'm in a foul mood because some fiends have been littering in our fair national park. Monsters.
The real monsters.
But you know what? It's all okay because we'll just clear it up like we always do. Then they'll just litter again and we'll clean it up again. It's the circle of rubbish, I tell you. Don't worry, I'm not going to make you clean the place up. That's what interns are for.
There's interns?
For you, I have a special
We're
mission.
Not an intern?
What? The tar pits in the park have started coughing up ancient artifacts.
Fuck.
Some of the visitors have handed them in. Old swords, a jewel-encrusted helmet, and a digital watch.
Lol.
Okay, that last one is going to the Lost and Found box rather than the Museum of Antiquities. Head to the pits and see if you can find any ancient goodies. What?
Ancient goodies.
The tar pits are exploding with ancient artifacts. They're coming up from beneath the earth.
I don't understand where you are that there would be swords and jeweled helmets in your tar pits.
Don't you remember the Civil War was here?
Yeah, great.
They used those during the Civil War.
They definitely had swords in the Civil War. Everyone, all officers had swords.
All officers had jewel-encrusted helmets.
It's true.
Only the officers from the north.
And a gentleman, at least, in those tar pits.
Only the officers from the north had jewel-encrusted helmets. My bad.
Yeah, get it right. Folks.
Fancy northerners.
They're also carried into battle on the backs of their men. There was
how many of them were carrying books with the method by which they could banish Alan back to his dark resting place.
Other Char says, the Chief Ranger is quite crafty. Thanks to Alan, he's wrong-footed the whole situation. No one will now suspect him. And he's free to go right back to, quote, cleaning up his beloved park. Yeah, that's it. Like, all of these, like, anytime something like this happens, it's a distraction. And as you guys note, like, the people who are in danger, we never get any clarification on what
Fox
happened to
Mulder
them.
Right now, like, I feel like every time we get so close and someone in the government just rips it out right from under us.
Like, and also like that, like, sometimes the darker truth is that there is no sleeping god. It's just a fucking crazy park ranger who kills people. Like, that's much darker than Alon or Zalgo is. This guy is just a fucking cannibal.
Here's my question. Have we ever had two missions back-to-back that involved finding people? Or is it always...
They always
like
space
an object
it out
mission,
like,
and then a person mission, and then an object mission, and then a part. Are we just giving him time? And then cleaning up?
They all just have move the body into the helicopter, Ranger. Don't worry about it. We'll take care of it from here.
And go find these shoes.
Dear Diary, today I decided to give up sharing my thoughts and dreams via the medium of pen and paper and bought a laptop. I hope you like your new life as an incongruous attraction in a national park. No hard feelings. I'll totally keep in touch. I value our friendship. .. They're not going to keep in touch.
It's a dick move.
Jokes.
Also right. Not an ancient artifact.
Shoes. Boots. I know the whole point of National Park is for visitors to get in touch with nature, but taking off your boots and wandering around barefoot just takes the biscuit. What? Who knows what you...
Biscuit.
Who knows what you might tread in? Our bears haven't been feeling too well lately. What?
What is happening?
Our bears
haven't
been
feeling...
He's taking the piss out of the bears.
No, he's taking the biscuit out of the bears.
No, taking the piss also.
Both?
Seriously, who is selling these things? I'm going to hunt them down and put a stop to the plague of rubber reptiles they've unleashed on our park. He did actually say there that he's going to hunt a man down.
Yep.
I don't think those are rubber. It's not the 50s.
He said before that he was going to hunt someone down. That's not the first time that he's
live
threatened
bait
to kill someone.
Oh, boy.
Ew, maggots. They don't half give me the shivers. What? Wait,
they
does that mean...
the full shivers.
Does that mean this someone was fishing
really
in the tar pits? What were they expecting to catch? A plesiosaur? 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 Whatever, I don't know.
Pleasure sore.
Yeah.
Is this half a bike?
Pleasure.
What is...
Get on it.
Well, you were gone, they've come.
It's just upright. It's just upright. It's fine.
Get on the bike. Climb on the bike.
I can't climb on it. There's nothing to... How do I...
Climb on the bike.
Okay, I'll do it.
A
bike? Wait, half a bike? How do you lose half a bike? They're not meant to come apart. The things you see in this job, Ranger.
They're not meant to come apart.
I bet that's the thing that they mount under your camera when you're riding a bike, and they had that model because they needed it, so they're just like,
toss
how do we
in.
I sure hope someone wasn't trying to beautify one of our bears with this comb.
That's a comb?
We're not even... By the bear cage.
What do you think happened to the real artifacts?
Whoa.
Do you think the real artifacts?
Are you guys, can you see this?
No.
Oh my god, that's awesome.
The tar is really thick, okay?
But this is like...
That's the side of the tar.
Okay. Uh-huh.
Can I go under it? I can.
Yeah, don't be careful, Phil.
No, I'm under it and I'm fine. Oh god, no, now I'm dying.
Yeah, of course you are. Your eyebrow deep in tar.
I mean, I wasn't, though, for a while.
Shaded Fox says, bikes for the bike god.
There's like a jaguar over there. What the fuck? They're watching me.
No pedals, no pedaling.
Snake spray.
Oh, nice. Take it.
For anti-snake spray to be truly effective, it has to be held and pointed and squirted by a person carrying it. You can't just leave it on the ground like some anti-snake claymore mine. Anti-snake claymore mine? Maybe we should look into this.
That's a wicked bad idea. Like, how do you know it's going to be a snake, not a dude? Or do you not care?
He doesn't care.
He doesn't care.
Another way to get kills. It is.
He just wants mace mines littering the park because it would make his work so much easier.
Very Ranger much Chief's so. KDR is off the charts.
His perks include...
He's only had 10 deaths.
Claymore mines peeing in the river.
He's got hundreds of kills.
Eagle.
He's only died 10 times.
Yeah.
What is that? But look at that thing.
I don't see it, Phil.
It's leading me
It's
somewhere.
A little cat.
Oh, I see
might
it.
Be the leader.
DSHS70 says, a person, how do you lose half a human? They're not meant to come apart.
What a waste. I could have used both halves.
Yeah.
I've been looking for somewhere to sleep. Is that a lion?
There's another. Yeah, it's like a cougar or something.
A puma, maybe?
Sure. All of these things. I have yet to find in a single thing that I would classify as an artifact, either with an E or an I.
I think all the real artifacts have sunk back into the earth. They've been reclaimed. It's definitely, it's shaped exactly like the hog, whatever that thing is. But it's got like just
it's a like the same tail. Like balls like the same hard, 3D rigging.
Like the body is the exact same shape and size, but like a little bit different tail.
I think they maybe bought some animal models and then like one or two animal animations.
Mm-hmm. But boy, do they buy a bunch of textures.
Yeah.
Be quiet.
I don't think they bought those textures. I'm going to sneak up on
him. Never mind. You ran away.
Mason.
Well, yeah, because they can sense you.
That's your
answer. There's something unclean upon your skin.
That's your answer to everything, Janine.
Yeah, well, you know.
What is?
Mason. Mason yeah. things.
Oh, okay, yeah. It's pretty useful.
Yeah.
It's also great on rice.
I don't know about that.
No, it is. It's hard to get a good hot sauce.
It was really, we didn't spend enough time just
praying?
Really, yes, that too. But just really focusing on the fact that, like, we, oh my god, I can't even.
Oh, this tree, what just this. Happened with that tree?
We didn't spend enough time really focusing on the fact that, like, the ground texture had a website, and, like,
yeah.
Like, that's pretty big. Like, that's a pretty, like,
yep.
Something went wrong there.
Mm. Yeah.
I'm not even willing to say it was, like, a watermarked texture. I think it might have just been, like, a photo that was on that website, like a photo of a mountain. Because that texture was bad enough that they could have just mm-hmm. taken a really big photo of a mountain and stretched it out and just said, we're going to use this rocky chunk. This is our rock mm-hmm. texture now.
But to, like, miss the fact that, like, that URL was printed there.
Austin, what did you say that the website did?
It looked like, I'm telling you.
Was it a giant bank? Was it a bank?
No, it wasn't a bank. It was like a German industrial company. They do a little bit of everything.
Some sort of umbrella corporation.
Yeah.
It just said Evil Shell. Evil Shell Corp. Evil Shell Corp.
I'm gonna.
Although their picture here, their like main picture was like a bunch of water, and what if like a year ago that was a bunch of rocks?
True.
That's all I'm saying. Mm-hmm. Raster Academy.
Yeah, I've looked all around that site. It's there's Vacation? There's a lot of weird shit on that site.
Oh, that's like a German word. Okay.
Yeah, you have to translate it.
Some of these are in English.
Raster School of Dark
Projection,
Arts.
Projection, Muse, Vecatures, Raster Academy, Contact, Raster Holding / Products. What language are you? Pick one. That's all I want.
They use lots of languages.
They're involved with Siemens. The company.
They're involved with what?
The company Siemens.
Oh, okay, yeah. Wait, their headquarters is like right next to my.
Yeah.
Excuse me? What are you?
Jizz jokes. We're making jokes about jizz. This is where we're at now.
And then, like, tech industrial company.
Phil, you need to find an artifact.
I'm looking. I'm trying to find anything.
No, Phil, you need
a tie. Does this count? A tie. Just what have people been getting up to in our park? It's supposed to be a place of peace, nature, and education. Not, well, random acts of passion. He seems to be associating ties with sex.
It's because someone took off their tie to get down.
Right.
It's because he's really into autoerotic asphyxiation.
To be honest.
He's also just erotic asphyxiation.
Yeah.
Speaking of Mulder.
Yeah.
Aw.
Did he do that?
Hmm.
To be honest, guys, I usually keep the tie on.
But that's it? No shirt?
Just the tie.
Just the tie?
I put on three ties. It's really good.
If you go to raster.net, it's a bunch of safety harnesses and safety equipment and fall arrest systems.
Wait, but cheap, can we go back? Is David Duchovny a known autoerotic asphyxiate?
I think he was like The Duke. That's someone... what I'm calling David Duchovny from now on. The Duke.
The Duke.
Yeah, get on board, everybody.
There was like someone who predicted the future and said that said that the character was gonna die of autoerotic asphyxiation or something. If I recall correctly. That's the bit there.
Yeah, Spooky Eddie says there's a joke in the X-Files that that's how Mulder dies.
Oh, okay. Listen, he's had a rough life.
Yeah.
Ah, the drinks can, the icon of littering. That and those poor abandoned shopping trolleys. There's nothing quite so melancholy as a shopping trolley poking out from beneath the water of a pond. We've yet to see a quote-unquote shopping trolley, so...
We've also yet to see a living human.
Yeah, that is accurate.
Or I'm sure we've seen bodies, moving bodies, but I can't say for sure that we've seen living people.
I think that cougar ran out from the tar pits.
Yeah, I was about to say the same.
That's where he was birthed.
Are his teeth saber-like?
He doesn't have teeth. He just has tendrils of darkness extending from his mouth.
I'm pretty sure the tar pit is the dark womb of the universe.
Soltron just says Sophie knew. Which I like. Miss Sophie.
My God, what did you read in her journal?
Can't repeat it.
You're shaking, Ranger.
My God.
Are you still looking for artifacts?
Yeah.
All right. There was a tie. Was it not that tie?
No, it wasn't the tie.
It's never the tie.
The tie just means sex. Apparently.
God, this game's so creepy.
I'm not sure why you haven't checked out the pumas. Maybe those are the artifacts.
Don't go in there, man. Yeah, he's just running through the tar pit.
It's almost like he wasn't programmed to know it's there.
Almost. Phil, how have you not found it? Maybe it's in the tar pit. Maybe you do have to go in.
I don't think that's... But it said that they've been, like...
You have to go in.
Up. They've been throwing up.
Yeah, no, I can't go... I can't go, like, under, so it would have to be on the surface. And I can't... Hey, here's something. A picnic basket.
Open it.
Nothing says romantic picnic like tar.
True.
Yeah, don't. What the fuck?
Hey, babe, don't I was thinking maybe we should go out for a picnic. Thinking about maybe going by the tar pit.
They thought it was a good idea. It's that they didn't and couldn't think differently.
Something drew them there.
They were called to the tar pit.
You've never seen the tar pits. They're very commanding.
Yeah.
Don't resist.
Become one of us. Enter the tar pit. Hey, Animal, have you seen...
Yes,
is it that rucksack? Was it the rucksack there?
I already
saw an Enderman.
No, that's... no.
It was like a tall, blocky, square thing.
It was probably a rock.
Wait, Entimus?
It was yeah, I saw a cake. Saw a big cake.
Man, I would like a shitty cookie right now.
I have some of those.
Park Adventure Monthly, the same one.
Maybe some Hydrox?
This is real...
Can you use help?
Yeah, I just
did
again.
He's been using help, I promise. The area that it's giving him is smaller and smaller each time, and there's this, I don't know where it could be.
It's super tiny now.
Do you think it's above you?
Oh. Have you looked up, Phil?
It's in the sky.
Is it maybe inward?
Oh, wait. I didn't see this.
I found the artifact.
The one ring!
What the fuck?
Fucking hell.
What's scrawled on it? What are those markings?
Stink.
What are these markings and why do they seem so familiar?
I've seen them before.
Looking at it makes my head hurt.
A gold bracelet. Just look at it. Look at how it shines. And what about those carvings? Exquisite. The Museum of Antiquities will be pleased with this. Maybe they'll call it the Ranger Bracelet. O'Farrell Bracelet?
Is that his name?
His name O'Farrell?
Oh my god.
I think it's O'Farrell.
Is this I'm pretty sure. Is this like a... This could be a major revelation for the plot.
Ranger O'Farrell. That's pretty sinister.
Ranger, we've got another missing camper. What is it with these campers? Always getting into trouble, never a moment's peace, I tell ya. Anyway, this guy has clearly been reading his outdoor survival handbook. What do you mean the dog ate yours? What? Seems he left a date and time for his friends to raise the alarm if he hadn't returned. Good thinking. Shame he didn't mention where he was going in the park. But it's better than nothing. I suggest we start at the campsite, head southeast to the camp, and see what you can find.
Wait, so then he did tell you where he was going. The campsite.
Well, we know he was camping at his campsite. But we don't know where
he
went.
Oh, but
from
he
there.
Okay, I see. I thought it was like, I'm going camping. If I'm not back by this time, call this creepy ranger I met in my dreams.
Atmit says, O'Farrell hungers. O'Farrell.
O'Farrell.
Been trying to put a name to our fears for so long. Could that be it?
No.
Wait, could what be what?
Okay.
What's going on?
I'm trying to figure out what the etymology of O'Farrell is. I'll get back to it.
The etymology, you're getting deep into this.
It means dark master in the old tongue.
In the old tongue, yeah, exactly.
That boar is running away like he knows something.
I just went to ancestry.com and I looked up Ranger O'Farrell.
Uh-huh. And just pictures of different types of blood.
Different types.
That's what ancestry.com does. Yes, they show you blood.
Well, no, they don't. That's why it's awful that they did this.
Ranger Ian O'Farrell came over during the potato famine. Over 100 years ago. Well, it'd be much more than 100 years ago. A long time ago. He's an old dead guy. That's my joke. Uh-oh. He's an old dead guy, Ranger.
But he isn't dead.
I mean...
Wait, did you
maybe
actually read
dead
this?
Isn't the right word.
No, what are you talking about? I just made everything up.
Did you?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes.
The Tahoma Mining District below Eagle Cliff.
What?
The North Mowich Glacier Eagle Mine Cliff? At the base of Eagle Cliff by the headwaters of the Mowich River was operated by the Washington Cooperative Mining Syndicate and was one of several claims in the area called the Mountain View Group.
Oh, God.
It had a half dozen buildings, including a sawmill and a blacksmith shop. There were numerous prospector cabins. The trail to the mining area branched off of the old grindstone trail. When Ranger O'Farrell went looking for the mine, he reached the end of the grindstone trail, then had to climb ladders to reach the mouth of the tunnel. The miners hauled the equipment in from Ording and must have done it by sled in winter because it was too heavy for horses. It was believed that this claim contained gold, silver, and cobalt ores. Ranger O'Farrell, who investigated the mine in 1908, concluded that this was a valid claim, even though there was no road for taking the ore. There's a whole history of Ranger O'Farrell here. In the Pacific Northwest. This is a whole thing. I don't mean to alarm you, but this is a whole
Eagle
thing.
Eagle Cliff? Is that what they...
Eagle Cliff.
Eagle.
Thomas O'Farrell.
Like what he transformed into.
When he reached the mountain, when he reached the sun, you mean?
Yes.
Right. No, he's a dude. This is a thing.
Bloodfist says, is this creepypasta? Yes.
Hang on, I found another post. According to Aaron O'Farrell of the Rangers, who twisted the twine 3 times in the game, the biggest factor in the win was a bit of luck and some good passing from his teammates. O'Farrell scored midway through the game.
No,
that sounds right. Keep going.
The 48-minute mark then capped the scoring off for the Rangers late in the game.
Oh, that is spooky. Too spooky.
Where is Eagle Cliff?
One second.
Where isn't Eagle Cliff?
T- To Ranger LeFerrell, the mill site claim did not appear to be made in good faith, but rather appeared to be an attempt to acquire the large trees. What's in the trees? Why did they want to acquire the trees?
Why are we drawn to the trees?
The following year, Alon reported that Ranger LeFerrell...
Wait,
...from the miner's cabin.
Shut up, wait.
...that the miners had wiped out the goat population in the basin.
Austin, yeah. Stop. Alon?
It's right here. The following year,
Alon.
Yeah, I do. That Ranger LeFerrell had confiscated rifles from the miners' cabins. He took their rifles, Phil. He said they couldn't have them.
What? Why? Who? What kind of monster would take their guns?
The government.
Now that I think about it, we haven't seen any goats, have we?
No goats.
By the way, there's unless it's a different Eagle Cliff, there is a big dilapidated graveyard with a giant mausoleum on Eagle Cliff.
Where's your Eagle Cliff at?
Illinois.
Oh, this seems to be...
There we go.
Oh, no, this Eagle Cliff is on Mount Rainier, which is in Washington State.
Okay.
This is a Gone Home sequel. I mean, I guess it's not in Washington, that's in Oregon, right? Yeah.
I feel like everything goes a lot deeper than we had realized at first.
Uh-huh.
I feel like...
So you're saying that when you guys and me were assuming that this game actually had some sinister things in it on purpose... It's even more crazy than that, where there's literal like weird connections to actual places and people.
Right, that's the actual yes.
I think, okay. I mean, I think.
Do you think Ranger O'Farrell made this game?
Here's the thing: is I think we're at a precipice right now. We have to decide, like,
are we going over?
Are we going to commit to doing this? Are we going to be the ones who solve this mystery? Because at a certain point. You can't turn back from this anymore. You know, you're too deep in, and the voices just keep telling you to keep looking. And
my voices are telling me to jump.
Yeah, I hear that one too.
Okay, as long as I'm not crazy.
No. But yeah, I just you know like I think if we want to back off, you got to do it now. But I don't know that I can back off.
This thing about Ranger O'Farrell also mentions an arsenic mine, and that would explain a lot. the deaths. A lot of the deaths.
Right.
The spontaneous Soltron deaths notes aren't up, addressed.
Soltron notes, we have played right into its hands. Other Char says, I can hear the fake trailer voice now. It was supposed to be a simple simulation. I don't like... Ugh. Looking for footprints in this game is not...
Mm-hmm.
Good.
Are you implying that this game is not optimized for usability and visibility?
No, I wouldn't say anything like that. I wouldn't say it harsh like that.
No.
I'm not mean like you, Janine.
The arsenic mines made me what I am.
Oh, they're fucking there. Oh, god damn it. I'm just going to ask for help right away. Oh. Phone.
I'm really love that the footprints you always find are not what walking footprints look like.
No, it's like someone had just like a shoe on a stick and was pounding them into the ground.
It's just like someone stood in one place and then they took like five, they took a step like 5 inches forward and stood there for a bit, then took another step and stood there for a bit.
Or it was a person with regular sized feet and 3-inch legs.
Or 4 legs.
Or 6 legs.
Yes.
Right.
The Block Monument.
Someone who scuttles.
Of course, the missing camper was going to the Block Monument.
What's the Block Monument? Is that giant black
the fucking thrumming obelisk?
Square? It's the one that like it feels like it's screeching in your head.
Oh, yeah, I remember that one.
Yeah.
I had a picnic there yesterday.
Did it pull you in?
No, but I lost a lot of the actual picnic food.
Zombie Manos says, kind of want to make a sandwich or two. And Crockbox says, you might as well, Manos. We don't know how deep this bear hole goes.
Ankle deep.
But no further.
No further and no dancing.
No beef, no mustard.
Boxing D-Horse says, I think this game is a prequel to The Legend of Grimrock. Man, I really like that game.
The game was kind of cool.
Yeah.
It was hard, but I had a lot of fun with it. It was really creepy.
I enjoyed things about it. And I'm glad they're doing another one. I'm glad it was successful.
Ooh, they are? Great.
Yeah, they're doing a sequel that's like kind of a bigger, more blown out thing. I think it's like not just one dungeon and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
It was one dungeon, but it was a really big dungeon.
Yes. My problem with Legend of Grimrock was just how, like, later on in the game, the further in you got, the more that, like, I don't know, like, the only way you could really stay alive was just, like, cheesing the AI.
Really? I didn't feel that way. I feel my biggest problem later on in the game was, like, not being able to find things that I needed to progress. Like, there was one part I was stuck for, like, 2 or 3 hours.
Sure, that definitely happened as well.
A part in a little room.
I felt like there was a lot of, like, the only way I felt like I could defeat some of the more powerful creatures was, like, to do the weird, like, slash at them and then move to the right.
Yeah, because you move faster than they do.
Yeah.
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 Oh, is that not, like, part of the game?
No, I think it is part of the game.
Okay.
That's not super interesting strategy to me. I just found that kind of, like, boring.
Yeah.
I'm used to, I went in, this is kind of my bias with that game, because it's kind of based on, there are a couple of different old school RPGs it's based on, but the old school RPG that I'm familiar with is the Might and Magic series, mm-hmm. and those were turn-based, and like you couldn't just like move to the side like that.
It bothered me a lot because so much of that game felt so immersive and that part didn't.
Yeah.
Like that part reminded me, right, I'm 4 people moving as one and what we're doing actually kind of doesn't make a lot of sense. Like the way things are moving and interacting in this world doesn't make sense compared to a lot of the areas where you were like looking around and finding stuff and planning out approaches and all that stuff felt really good to me, but the combat just completely took me out of that.
I still liked it. Yeah, it was just a...
Yeah.
That...
It was still good. It was just...
That made it less good than it could have been, I guess, for me.
Captain O'Farrell mm-hmm. of the Hartford branch became the possessor of the chair in which Robert E. Lee sat. A child's doll was found in the room.
Oh my God.
The younger
what?
Officers tossed from one to the other and called the Silent Witness.
Jesus.
Oh my
Are you
God.
Serious?
The toy was taken possession by of Colonel Moore, the Sheridan staff, and is now owned by his son. Bargains were at once struck for nearly all the articles in the room, and it is even said that some mementos were carried off for which no coin of the Republic was ever exchanged.
The Silent Witness.
Can I say that the Silent Witness is the 3 creepiest words next to each other? Like, is it... I just imagine, like, a doll with like it's a doll and it's small, but it has a real face with the mouth stitched closed.
Austin, can I ask? So, if I'm understanding the context of this right, is this people picking up like the stuff left over from Ranger O'Farrell after he's dead?
No, this is Captain O'Farrell of the O'Farrell clan. Sure. After the Civil War, taking the Silent Witness from the room that saw Robert E. Lee concede the Civil War. The Silent Witness was in the room when the Civil War ended. You might remember this game has a Civil War monument.
There's a Civil War connection. It's getting creepy.
Brilliant?
I don't want to think so. Or I do want to think so more than anything, but I don't really think so. Yet.
New type lady linked to a Wikipedia for Robert the Doll?
Yeah, I'm not. That's too creepy.
What is that?
That's some other haunted doll.
I'll click on it.
I've clicked on it. It seems to be too broadly unrelated. I only draw legitimate connections, you guys. Obviously.
I think the thing to emphasize here is that we're not just seeing connections where they don't exist.
Right.
We are, in a lot of ways, I think, the only people who can see the truth.
That's completely the accent. Yeah, that's it.
And that's, you know, anybody who says otherwise, they're just trying to mislead you. They're trying to turn you away from the truth.
Follow the money, you know?
We've been following the money here on this stream for over a year now. And I think, how many other streams out there are following the money?
My stream's following the money, I think.
And that's why we bring you on.
This is just a group of people all looking for that green.
We can trust you because you're following the money.
Yeah.
And I don't feel like a lot of streams are, though. I don't feel like most other people, they don't have the truth in mind. They're not looking behind the curtains like we are.
Mm-hmm.
They're not peering behind the veil, so to speak.
They're not shattering the glass between worlds.
Yes. They're not searching for fucking footprints.
Oh, you can buy a Feral bracelet right now on Cafe Press.
Oh my god, somebody linked a picture of the Silent Witness and it's horrifying.
Oh, wait, where is that at? I need to see that.
It's in the chat. Holy ETI shit. Did.
Oh my Christ.
That is a million times worse.
I'm
going to
link this in our Skype chat.
When we're done with this mission, I can bring it up on the actual
Please
thing.
Do.
But I need to finish this mission first because we're being timed.
We need someone to take that picture and go into Photoshop with it, remove the doll's ankles, and then animate it going back and forth. That would be A+.
Jesus
Christ.
That's the fucking worst thing.
It's really scary.
I can't tell if its face is stained or if it's supposed to have a weird marble face.
Did you ask why did Captain O'Farrell want? Why do you think Captain O'Farrell wanted it?
Was it supposed to be like that? It wasn't supposed to be.
Think about it. Follow the money.
I'm not going to read this whole thing, but the National Park Service has a thing on the Silent Witness doll. And the reason the National Park Service does it, this is like a thing written from the doll's perspective.
Oh my god.
And at the end of it, it says Lula, who I think was the doll's owner, is long gone. Our house was dismantled and reconstructed. The whole town of Appomattox Courthouse is now a national park, and I am famous. They turned that place into a national park.
Is that for real?
That is for real.
Can you link that? I don't even believe you.
Oh.
my God, it's a national park.
Yeah, I know.
Dude, what?
I know.
Wait, is this written from the perspective of the doll?
Yeah, I said that out loud.
I didn't believe you.
I don't lie about important things.
And I am famous. I'm in the museum. But my favorites are the children. Did you read that part?
I didn't read that part.
It says, I am in a museum visited by hundreds of people every day, but my favorites are the children.
It all seems so long ago, back before the late unpleasantness.
It does say that.
What?
It says the late unpleasantness.
Oh my God, this game is literally trying to make me explode. This is what Assassin's Creed 3 and 4 were missing. Shit like this.
Parks. More footprints. Do they look wonky to you? As though our man were a bit dizzy? Let's see. He went to the block monument, and then he wandered away dizzy. Wonder what could have happened. I wonder what he saw.
Assassin's Creed 2 and Brotherhood had, like, this sort of crazy means something else.
Whoa.
Like, I swear to God, I was on, like, a 5 or 6 hour long, like, Link binge while playing the Assassin's Creed games because there's so much there to find out. It's like this game, like, every time you look up something, it links to something else that is somehow crazily relevant.
They changed the model. His shoe's untied.
Oh, my God. They were trying to get at his ankles.
Giant hands. Just terrifying hands. Our missing camper has been found. He's looking dehydrated, so call in an evac quick.
He has the hands of, like, a gray alien.
Okay, let me... let's do a couple of quick side things before we go into the next mission. First off, credits. We need to see what's going on.
We need to see. What if they're...
Published by Excalibur Publishing.
What is this written
Unicron Software. Mission Designs. Here we go. Tim Boss. Sandy Steele.
Those are English names.
The QA is the people who did mission design.
Mick O'Farrell!
Who's Mick O'Farrell?
I don't know.
Also, so it's literally like five or six people who worked on
Mick O'Farrell, known for his work on Pineapple Express?
No, probably not, Keith.
Mick O'Farrell Bishop?
Probably.
Oh my God.
Alright, I found Unicron Software. Wait. I'm glad that you did that because now we have video record of people's real names on this.
Well, maybe real.
Yeah, it's true.
I'm gonna throw in here we go. This is the silent witness on screen right now. Just want everybody to be able to see this. I want it to be on the video for when this goes up on YouTube.
I found another good excerpt.
Maybe just leave this. Silent witness. Maybe just leave this in the. God, that is creepy. Look at the face.
I know.
It's just really watching.
It's like the worst shit in the world.
They all laughed again and again, and he threw me against the room at a man called Michael Sheridan. Then I was thrown again at another man who turned out to be an officer on General Philip Sheridan's staff. I had never been treated that way before, except once by Lula's brother, John Wilmer, and her daddy soon took care of that.
Oh.
He killed him. He killed them all.
Uh-huh.
No ragdolls, no dancing.
I just get... Look at her ankles.
That doll really is smeared with blood, though, right? Like, that's what that is.
Yep.
Just watching.
Shaded Fox says, stop, Phil, please.
Oh my God, I'm starting to see words.
What does it say?
It's just watching right now.
What if it says...
Admin says, how to get burned, how to get burned!
It was always burned.
Okay, that's gone. Sorry about that, guys.
When the silent witness was new, everything else was... No. Hold on. How do I say
it? I like that I have this here. Basically. It's in...
What if it says raster.com?
It's in Open Broadcaster Software now, so I can just, like, click over to this doll, just half of a doll's face watching anytime I want. Okay, sorry. I'm going to go on to the next mission. Bare Necessities. Yeah. Ranger, I'd like you to meet Dr. Theodore Ursa and Dr. Goldie Locke. They're experts on all things bear-related, even porridge. Basically, the two doctors would like to study the bears we have in our national park, but firstly, we need to work out where their territory is, and that's where you come in.
The bear cave.
Yeah, we figured it out. There we go.
That's where the bears go.
I've heard visitors mention sightings in the west area of the park. Head over there and see if you can find any signs of a bear or two. Some bear tracks would be just right. Get it?
Yeah, I get it.
Get
just right.
Get it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Can't find anything interesting about Mick O'Farrell.
They've erased all the real information. It's all gone now. I do know that O'Farrell in Irish Gaelic means man of valor.
Starcrash ebook linked to Unicron Software's Twitter account.
Yeah, I've seen it. Don't no one tell them that we found out yet.
Yet. What they've done. Don't tell them yet because we still have a lot of digging to do and we don't want them to know that we're on their
They could trail. Push an update to Steam right now and erase all of
Only
us.
279 followers.
We should all follow them.
I'll have to follow them right now.
Follow them, but don't say anything yet.
Yeah.
Just a little winky face, maybe.
I'm on to you.
Just say, we know.
We know.
Just say...
We know your fucking secret, you sickos.
We're drawn to the block monument.
Alan, Alan. Yai, yai, Alan.
Fuck. That's really funny.
There was a Mick O'Farrell on Twitter, and I was just hoping that the Twitter avatar was the silent witness. And, how amazing would that have been?
And that the only person following them is Unicron Software.
Just one big ARG.
God. Oh, hold on.
What?
Starcrash says maybe just tweet no ankles, no dancing.
Oh.
New type lady really likes we know.
Okay. I think that Mick O'Farrell could be a biological consultant that they got like park information from, possibly.
Mm-hmm.
He's a guy that has his. It's mammalogist.org, and he
mammalogist probably.
What did I say?
Don't worry about it.
Okay. He does biological consulting? I don't know.
That's a weird phrase.
Yeah, I don't know what it means. It's the only relevant information that I could find about it. No, this isn't the same type of thing.
No.
There's no way that he did that. Yeah.
I hope not.
Like, he does stuff about, like...
Is this the bear cave? Did I just discover the bear cave?
Maybe.
It looks like he does stuff like telling people if they're... Their windmills are going to interfere with bats.
That's not too far off,
I guess. There is the main picture on his thing is a gigantic bat. So, what are you when you come night, O'Farrell?
It happened again.
What happened again?
ZTI in the chat. Remember how I was telling you guys about how Thomas O'Farrell took away their guns in Washington?
Oh my god!
So, this is from last March.
Oh yeah,
New South Wales Labour opposition has today welcomed Barry O'Farrell, suspension of the amateur hunting and national parks program, and urged the Premier to kill off the dangerous policy altogether. A different O'Farrell half all the way across the world, on the completely other side of the world, in two different hemispheres, did the same thing. In a different park.
The same last name.
Follow the money.
Jesus, this goes deeper than we thought.
Listen, guys, this isn't about the
money. There's always an O'Farrell.
This is about the truth.
There's always an O'Farrell.
There's always an obelisk. There's always a national park.
New Type Lady is linking to a tweet on her Twitter account that I can't see. True. Someone should tell me what it is.
She says, no ankles, no dancing, hashtag RSRS.
Yep.
At Unicron. Somebody else pointed out that Unicron, it was Shaded Fox, Unicron follows no one on Twitter. They don't follow, they only watch.
Yeah, they don't follow like any of their employees. Who follows them? Who's their first
Where are they
follower?
Based out of?
By the way, they've gotten 15 followers in the last minute.
I know, and a lot of them
No
are
hashtags, no follows.
Where are they based?
They're gonna be so pumped.
Newcastle, England.
Huh. Well, that explains a lot of the weird like English stuff in here.
Newcastle upon Tyne. Teen Tyne?
Sure. Was that it? Okay, that was the whole mission. That was a short one.
It looks like all of their first four followers are all indie developers.
Okay.
That probably did some sort of work for Unicron. Another one, like almost all of the people's Twitter bios on the people that follow them are like indie developer that develops with Unity.
Yeah, and this was made with Unity, I think it said. So,
and a couple of dark priests too followed.
Oh, I love it. People in the chat are just linking their tweets now.
They've almost passed 300. They were at 280 or something.
We're making their weekend right now.
Yeah. No, they're pumped.
I guess.
I hope we can get somebody from Unicron Software on the show.
That's my goal in life. My new goal.
I just want to know.
Do you think that we should all tweet at them at the same time? No angles, no dancing?
I mean,
all at the same time?
I think all at the same time, maybe. Like, can we do that, please?
I'm not going to say no.
I was going to say, I don't want to scare them, but they've scared us.
Yeah, they've really scared us a lot.
That is true.
More than any other game that I've ever played, they have scared us. Oh my god.
What's up?
Is this the exit? It can't be.
No.
Can we
it
leave?
Doesn't exist.
Can we get
the phantom toll booth?
Welcome to the park. Why does it say welcome to the park on this side? We haven't been in park the whole time. Wait, this door is too small. This door is too small to get through.
And the gate is locked.
What's that sign say?
And there's nothing? No road that leads to it. There's no road. There's no parking lot.
Yeah, wait. What's on the other side? Look through the bars, Phil.
What
if he tells you, like, nope?
The ranger wouldn't... There's wildlife over there, too. The ranger won't let me leave. I need...
It's not your time. It's not your time.
Why do you keep saying that? What does it mean?
Like, it's not your time. You get on back now. You get on back. Stay away from those bars or something dangerous might come. Something might wake up and come.
This is bad.
I like the idea that his catchphrase is "You get on back."
You get on back.
You get
yeah.
Back.
Majestic.
Oh boy.
Majestic.
That bird looked like two flying socks.
That's not a bird. That was a cougar.
Oh, that wasn't a bird.
It was just running up the mountain cliff.
Oh no!
Oh, that's my only
majestic.
I hope. Oh boy! Oh boy!
Beautiful.
It vanished. Oh, wait, there it is.
Nature.
Yep, that's
nature's so beautiful.
There's definitely no way to get out of the game. Like, you can't climb over something.
I mean, I bet you there is.
Well, hold on. Maybe I can Skyrim up over this.
What if?
Oh my god, I think.
Oh, do it.
What? There's not. It's not even a challenge.
It's not just... even. Yeah, you just did it.
Phil, all... just go.
We escaped.
Wait, go read the sign. Go read the sign that's in front.
Oh my god.
There's a sign right in front of the gate. I need to know what it says.
It says, welcome to the park says backwards.
The little one.
Oh my god, no. Oh, this is fucked up. Super bad, you guys.
It's just a creepy, rusted Silent Hill sign.
Black sign.
All right, well, you know what you have to do, Phil.
We got
to
get out of here.
I don't think they're fucked up at all. I think that's exactly as it's meant to be.
Oh my god, they're all...
We finally made it. We got to go.
What you don't realize is the physical wall is just a ruse.
Yeah.
The real wall.
Oh my god, we can see, like, what happens over that edge.
Bring up the map.
We're almost home.
What if there's, like, voiceover? Stop.
What if it's voiceover and it's Phil's voice?
Wait,
saying stop.
Mr. WizKid's link in the chat.
In another world we've gone over. It's not worth it.
We've escaped!
No.
We finally made it. We finally made it.
There's nothing.
Well, that's...
Just look down. Hold my hand, Phil.
It's so much quieter.
I was almost expecting it to pull a faculty and just put you on the other side of the map.
Me too.
I can't believe they just didn't stop you. There was no wall. There was no anything.
I mean, there was a wall. It just wasn't really hard to get over.
What do you... If you left it here long enough, do you think you would reach a bottom?
No.
There's like a little platform down there.
No bottom. No. It always goes further.
We finally made it. The Chief Ranger can't hurt us here.
Call for help.
Can you bring a helicopter?
Nope.
We can travel. We can fast travel.
You should definitely fast travel.
Did we beat the game?
This is the only way to win.
What happened?
Helicopter arrives.
In 16 seconds. What if it's
filled with all the... Wait, so the pilot knows.
What if it's filled with all the bodies that he's putting into the helicopter? Crockbox says, congratulations, Shinji. fade to black.
We didn't even see the helicopter.
Nope.
It just dropped us off back inside. We tried it. We thought we could escape.
Nope. Oh, boy. Use that energy food mega.
I know I did.
Oh.
Oops. Well.
Soda Dreamer says, I love this stream.
Thank you, Soda Dreamer. I love you. I can't believe we escaped. We felt freedom, and then they pulled us back in.
And then they pulled us right back in.
Sent the helicopter. We couldn't even enjoy falling.
Look, it felt like freedom, but in, like, probably 5 minutes, we were just going to land on, like, a beach in Colombia, and it just becomes a different game. A different, arguably worse game.
Definitely.
Oh, wow, I parked my bike right by these.
I mean, I know that happened because we you know, broke the game, but
it's like,
I definitely hope that's part of Mike Danger's reality.
You guys,
where he literally fell off the edge of the earth, falling, like, no bottom, and then just a helicopter picked him up.
This guy we're looking for was right by the entrance. Why do you think he was by the entrance? He was fucking trying to get away. Leave.
Welcome to the park.
And the Chief Ranger is sending us to stop him.
Darth Cylon says, you became an eagle.
Now I know what the Chief Ranger meant. It's beautiful. It's so beautiful.
Soltron says, abruptly you wake up and it's jazz punk.
Oh, that'd be great.
That would be really good.
I love you. Bye bye.
Guys, I really like jazz punk a lot.
Yeah, it's really good.
We missed a really good opportunity. We missed a really good opportunity for a we gotta go back joke. This is definitely our lost. I know we streamed the lost game, but this is
our lost.
Our lost.
The lost game wasn't lost. Very much like lost.
No. You're saying lost via Domus, via Recovery Search and Rescue Simulation?
Exactly. By way of. Yep.
I have literally no... I should go back and watch that, because I don't remember a single fucking thing.
We played the whole thing.
I know, I was there.
Didn't we do it in one night?
I think it was two.
Two, yeah.
And I maybe wasn't there for the first
part. Maybe.
That might be. Listen, I don't remember much of it at this point either, so...
It was a long time ago. Everything was a long time ago.
Shitbox says Phil scratched out tarp of a face, but that's about it.
It's weird that he had a website on the texture for his face. That was strange.
Hurley's face was so broken.
Shitbox says Phil, are you starting to sympathize with Chief Ranger O'Farrell? Kind of.
He's seen some shit. Him and that little doll.
The silent witness.
Stockholm is real. You guys are Stockholmies.
What?
Wait, Stockholm the place is certainly real. You mean Stockholm Syndrome?
Yeah.
Okay.
There's debate as to whether that's a real thing.
No, that's also kind of a real thing. But
I thought you were really going to say this debate as to whether or not that's a real place.
Yeah, I was hoping for that, really.
Mm-hmm.
I was hoping that's the direction you'd take it.
It's the town right next to Stockholm who think that Stockholm totally sucks definitely does not consider it a place. There's a bit of rivalry between the local sports team of Stockholm and whatever's next to Stockholm.
No.
What?
Did you just Google O'Farrell Stockholm and...
No.
Ackersberga. That's what's next to Stockholm, and they hate each other. They're just jealous. They don't have their own syndrome.
The ZTI leaked a thing from conspiracyhq.com, obviously, called Mysterious Disappearances, National Parks, and the Breakaway Civilization. Evidence of batch consignments? And, like,
what?
I want to read this, but the whole thing is just so conspiracy jargony that
none
of it
makes
any sense. One of the things that's always been What is it?
I just fell.
Oh, okay. One of the things that's always been perplexing about the breakaway civilization was the notion of batch consignments. What is happening?
I love that it's just let's go right into this with the assumption that you have any knowledge at all of what the fuck
batch consignments was a term used in Alternative 3 to describe the movement of individuals off-world for use as slave labor to construct bases on the moon and Mars.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
So it's not when I bring a big garbage bag of clothes to the Salvation Army store?
No, it's not. That's not a bad consignment.
It's also not mass quantities of cookies.
What?
A batch of cookies.
Okay.
Yeah. Says most batch consignments, if they exist, can be attributed to. I like how there's kind of like a wiggle room, even on the conspiracy theory website. Most batch consignments, if they exist, can be attributed to political instability in the Third World.
Mm-hmm.
During these conflicts, entire villages could disappear without a trace.
Are they actually proposing that big groups of people in areas full of, like, civil unrest and serious bullshit were more likely abducted by aliens than killed by their government?
I think it's that they're abducted by the government to build government bases on the moon and Mars.
Mm.
I want to know if, like, someone who's, like, pretty sure that the moon landing was a hoax, but, like, if it wasn't a hoax, then there's people being building bases on Mars. Like,
I mean, just because you believe one conspiracy theory doesn't mean you believe all of them together, because that would be a really complicated way of living. I'm sure some people do, but they're probably a minority, right?
I don't know. There's someone on that I'm friends with on Facebook that I'm pretty sure believes all conspiracy theories.
Can we get them on the Skype call?
I think we all have one of those.
Yeah.
Are they a what?
Are they
a family member?
Are they an O'Farrell?
Is it
no.
Is it Kyle?
Are they a silent witness?
It's Kyle. I said I wouldn't tell. But Kyle's wicked into rods. He definitely thinks he believes in rods.
Right.
It's just artifacting. It's a government conspiracy.
When did this come out?
That way because he spent the past few years on the moon.
That's great.
The gravity really fucks up your muscles.
I spent 3 weeks in an underground lab. You have no idea the shit they did to me. They're working with the Greys. I mean, it says Kyle believes in Hypercube.
Yeah, well, that's just because it's true.
How do you watch this game and not believe in any and all cube theories?
Mm-hmm.
Wait, are there people who don't believe in Hypercube?
Keith, apparently.
I don't know what Hypercube is.
Don't worry about it. It knows what you are, so...
I know what Time Cube is. I know all about Time Cube.
I bet.
Guys, I can't find anything anymore.
What are you looking for? Bears?
Probably footprints, probably.
Mm-hmm.
They're kind of like unclear, but...
You're looking for the escapee, right?
Yeah. Specifically right now, I think I'm looking for his footprints. But let me try going down here.
I think what you need to ask yourself is, when you were in your weakest state of mind, what feature of the park draws you towards it the most?
All right, I do have to read this one part of this ridiculous conspiracy theory site, because it seems relevant. There is another mystery that was discovered by researcher and ex-police officer David Paulides. Paulides has undertaken research into disappearance clusters, and his research has proved some very interesting results. On one hand, he has documented numerous cases where, in national parks, children have disappeared within feet of their parents, only to be found miles away, and sometimes even over mountain ranges, with no recollection of how they got to that location. In other cases, he has documented cases where people simply vanished, leaving their clothes in a pile as if they were snatched from within their clothes. Their clothes simply piled where the person had been standing. In both cases, dogs are unable to pick up the scent, which is strange. It was as if the person just dematerialized. How many times have you just found weird clothes in this national park, Phil?
Pretty much constantly.
Pretty much constantly.
That's like the only thing you find. That and bodies.
and inhalers everywhere.
That's part of clothes.
Mm-hmm.
Inhalers are just clothes medicine.
What?
Yeah, it's medicine you keep in your clothes.
Shut up.
No, this is for real. I'm being serious right now.
You put on your serious voice for that.
Yeah.
For that.
Yeah. They're like, okay, so think about it. What are you going to do? Carry it around? No, you put it in your pockets. Clothes medicine. I don't get it. What is the...
What medicine don't you do that with?
Aspirin?
What?
Where do you? You don't carry on aspirin, you just take it. If anything, it's in a bottle in your glove compartment.
He's gone! So it's He's lost medicine. It! Have you guys ever heard a person lose their fucking mind? Live? Because he just did. It was just now, and it was Keith Carberry, everybody.
Look, there's two kinds of medicine. There's clothes medicine, and then there's cabinet medicine.
No, it's not what he said. He didn't say cabinet. He didn't say, you keep it in the cabinets. He said, you just take it.
Car medicine.
You just take it.
Well, some medicine, like special, there's special medicine that you have to inject, but otherwise, you're putting it in your mouth.
also special medicine.
Yeah.
It's mouth medicine, clothes medicine, and special medicine.
New Type Lady asked if it was me who just said that. Though. No, that was Keith. I'm Phil, and Keith will talk right now.
Hello, I'm Keith. What's going on?
So that's, we both sound very different and not like two white dudes.
Yep.
But I'm a doubts.
To be fair, we both sound wicked like two white dudes.
Yeah, I know.
What's, wait, go back. There was something crawling on the ground.
Was it a snake? It was probably
there was
a
like
snake.
A black, there was like a black dot crawling across the ground.
What?
A bug.
No.
Shadow? It looked like a bug, but it was all black.
Wait, some I can bugs hear are something. All black. Hold on.
A lot of
hold
bugs
on.
Are...
Guys, shh, shh, shh.
I think I see some clothes medicine. You guys know that I was way kidding, right?
No.
I guys, was... hold on. I can't. No, seriously, be quiet because I can hear something.
Okay.
I don't know if it's important, but I'm trying to follow the sound. Nope. It's not working. Now I'm scared.
Never in my life have I more wished that I could make convincing duck calls.
Spooky says, wait, I thought Kyle was on this stream. Nope.
Oh.
He's probably sleeping because he's boring.
Jeez.
No, it's true, though.
It's super boring.
I'm hearing...
Last time I was at his house, he made me spend 3 hours looking at his photo album of different types of clothes medicine.
Wait, what? I don't even...
They were all beige washed. Everything was beige.
You're inventing whole phrases now.
Also, like, you're still kidding, but you still sound fucking crazy.
Yeah.
I know. I'm being fun.
No.
No? This isn't fun?
You're...
like, why? I don't see how this is any weirder than talking about Zelgo.
Well, one of them is real.
Star Crash ebook says... At I'm Silent Witness hasn't tweeted yet.
Yeah, that makes sense.
It's a real account.
How long has it been active for?
It's new.
No followers?
It's following Unicron software.
Okay, there we go. I'm a little worried that you guys don't know that I was kidding. The whole, like, for real, the whole
it's
time.
It's fine.
Okay.
Don't worry
we're
about
not,
it.
We're not gonna, like...
I'm judging you.
There we go, see? Listen, I'm not that worried about you guys. I'm worried about Phil.
8 seconds. I think
Phil's
I can beat this mission.
Doesn't matter.
That's pretty true.
Yeah.
I'm kidding.
What does Phil know about The Last of Us?
Mission is over. Out of time.
Oh, well, what's
that? It was a dumb mission anyways. Mission unbearable? That sounds fun. Ooh, Big Cat Diaries.
Don't
it just looks like meat. It just looks like meat.
It looks
it's
like
so
meat.
Gross. It's so gross. It's so gross.
It looks like partially cooked
also
meat from a body.
The people on the stream couldn't see it, but Phil just dragged that onto our screen share
yeah.
so that
you
could see it.
Still wants you to know that it was watching you, too.
Well, I can see it. There it is.
Ranger, the gray fox flies at night. No, I'm not going mad. Did you notice that aeroplane flying over the park earlier? Aeroplane. No, what were you doing? You've got a job to do, you know. Anyways, turns out that was a spy plane. So your next mission, should you choose to accept it, is top secret and completely hush-hush. So secret, in fact, that you'll have to do it at night, I'm not joking. It seems that mysterious plane was dropping a package from the sky for an agent to collect in the park. Naturally, the package looks like a walker's rucksack, so as to not draw attention to itself.
Psy? What is the Psy for?
Said agent missed the drop on account of being held prisoner by a nefarious criminal organization hell-bent on global domination, or a flat tire or something. Tire, T-Y-R-E, of course. I wasn't really paying attention, so they've asked for us to retrieve the package and keep it safe until it can be picked up. Do Hold not on. Look inside this package. Not sure about you, but I'm not quite ready to be dealt with by shady government agency. Who'll look after my cat?
It said, so who, a nefarious criminal organization hell-bent on a flat tire or something?
On global domination.
But, or the, a flat tire.
The flat they tire, no. The flat tire was... That might have also been what kept the spy from picking up the package.
Oh, okay. Now I get it.
Atmid says, Gray Fox? Frank Yeager?
CG Runyon just says, there's a map carved in her heart. Look inside, it is yours.
Oh, but I think the next mission is called Carry On Campsite.
Oh,
which, like, is
that.
Super creepy.
Mm-hmm.
Because it sounds like carrion campsite.
Well, look, Here's the thing about this. What's more plausible here? That some sort of spy organization dropped a backpack of spy stuff in the middle of your park, and the spy who was supposed to get it got hung up doing other spy things. Or the murderous ranger is sending you after a rucksack full of limbs, which he doesn't want you to look into it.
Don't
look in there. Because it's spy stuff.
Last time
spy
you told
stuff.
You not to look at something, you looked at it and you were left a broken man.
And it was also near the Needle Monument. So
I'm probably gonna look at it again. Oh my god,
yeah,
the monument.
I think that's his kill site.
The monument.
I think this whole place is his kill site.
Yeah, that's probably true.
I think every time there's a tree, a leafless tree with misshapen arms, it's because there's a human person buried underneath.
I think
so
that this monument might be the epicenter because its shape sort of channels all of the darkness from the land upwards and outwards like an antenna.
It does sort of look like somewhere that the Crimson King would hang out.
The Crimson King, of course, Keith's wrestling name.
Mm-hmm.
Made your WWE debut this week. Very proud.
Yep, kick some ass.
Mm-hmm.
I won everything. Everything that I did, I won.
All of the.
I won everything.
All the things, all the things that you did.
I used the jump ones,
mm-hmm.
And then
the
I hit. Yeah, I used the jump thing, and then I hit one of the.
Gave that guy the clothes
one of the
medicine.
Other,
that's
the yeah,
Keith's
yeah.
finisher. Is what? The clothes medicine?
It's a key. Yeah. I clotheslined him.
Clothes medicine. That's right.
Yeah.
That's what you call it. It's a special.
I just sprayed him. Really, what happened was I sprayed him in the eyes with an inhaler, and then I just kicked him. Just kicked him real hard.
Mm-hmm.
And the ref didn't say anything because it was scripted. It's all fake.
My
whoa,
computer
whoa,
just
what?
Freaked out in the most alarming way, but now it's
whoa.
Fine. So
where
I got a lot of like spasming black stripes. Was...
Wait, for real?
Yeah.
Okay, great. It's not the worst.
It's fine now. I don't know what happened.
You have tons of points. You should just
call in 16 helicopters and make them fight each other.
There are a lot of people in the chat.
The bear was attracted to the smell that was inside the bag. The meat flesh.
There are a lot of people in the chat doing emote stuff, which I'm weirded out by, but okay with.
What?
I don't understand.
Flailing Art says, what doesn't kill me only makes me riot.
This is all... I don't understand. Clisp says, what doesn't kill you makes you donger.
Yep. That's
great.
I think half of them are talking about rioting, and then the other half are talking about doing Molly, and a combination of
Molly. I think is what we call it.
A combination of that. Well, then you do it also.
No, you just pop it.
You can pop it or do it. You can't do it. You can only pop it.
Yeah, you can only pop it.
So do you think Unicron Software sent them?
Yes.
Matt Mitchell says, Keith, teach us more of your medicine. I don't, that's all I know.
What is it?
I'm not a nurse. I'm not a clothes nurse.
Oh, I think it's people from Dacid, bro. So there we go.
That makes sense.
That follows.
Uh-huh. People from what?
Dacid, bro. He's in the chat with us now as well.
Okay.
A spy bear planted in the park by the enemy.
Oh, look at that raccoon or a wolf or something. What's that thing floating in the horizon?
Park like this, it could be.
Hold on, let me see if I can. I think I'm starting to make it out. There it is. Yeah.
God. Actually, when it's cut off like that, it just looks like a little cookie.
Delicious.
Looking at it just makes me hungry now. The hunger grows.
Agent Bear.
This guy loves bears.
Bears love him too, you know? Ooh, it's a map.
A tie. And a tie. Sex was going on.
Sex tie.
Probably. I mean, I assume that's what ties are for, right?
I didn't read
the
thing. Was he talking about sex again?
I don't know. I didn't really read it either. To be honest with you, I didn't read it either.
Okay. At this point, that's fair.
I'm Silent Witness on Twitter has tweeted its first tweet at Unicron Software, no ankles, no dancing, hashtag RSRS.
I hope they don't think people want to murder them.
They get That's it. That's my concern. Their game.
I don't know if the people in charge of the Twitter account will get
credits.
There's documents in the woods.
You don't think that one of those 10 people in the Twitter credits knows about no ankles, no dancing? Also, I don't know if anyone else tweeted at them no ankles, no dancing, but...
No, like everybody did.
Everybody did? Okay.
Yeah.
Because I did suggest it, but then I never did it. Because I'm not a lunatic.
You should. It's gonna be.
I like. It's really too. Convincing when you say you're not a lunatic and follow it up with laughter like that.
With a laugh. Yep. Why'd you find a can of maggots? Ugh.
Fell out of the bag.
I'm not a lunatic. 10 minutes of laughing.
Listen, I'm just a happy guy.
Is that? Oh my God!
That's Agent Bear. He's lumbering or something.
That's not how bears walk.
Run!
Excuse me.
Oh my God! Run!
I'm looking for stuff over here. What are you? Leave me alone, man. Yeah, you better run.
What scared him away? What did you do?
I didn't do anything. Look at
that. You flap your arms. They hate that. I read. Look
behind you. What did it see?
It could sense something on your skin.
It was about to bite into my flesh, and then it was like, no, this one is impure.
Alon claims
that that running animation is so bad.
It's really pretty bad.
Oh.
CG Runyon says the bears know. He's talking about an erect rod. Good job, guys.
More tracks.
They say an animal can sense when the storm's coming. Ranger Danger, you're the storm.
Yep. Oh, is this documents? A sketchbook. Nuclear bunker locations, weapon caches, security codes, Elvis.
Uh-huh.
Best this forget what we saw, Ranger, and get those back to their rightful owner. Ugh.
I'm and like the sketch of the obelisk again.
I'm pretty sure that like nuclear, locations where we have our nuclear bombs are like public record, right?
Ranger, have you heard of Professor Felix Whiskers? No, well, me neither until today. Anyway, Professor Whiskers is an expert in big cats.
No, it's not. He's an expert in big cats.
Big cats. Not sure why I went all dramatic there, but the term big cats seems to justify it. He's in the park to study the mountain lions that live here, but the thing is, and I'm sure this is going to come as a major surprise to you, he's only gone missing in the park.
Another victim. How incompetent are all the professionals that come here to do their job?
Another victim.
They're not incompetent. It's just that Chief Ranger O'Farrell is very
smarter than all of them.
Another victim. Another day in the park. Another poor innocent fool dead.
Worst places to die. This park will take care of you after you die.
You become one with it.
Give you a reason to stick around.
Part of the family.
Most places don't do that.
Become part of the family.
A lot of times in life it feels like you ain't part of nothing. This park gives you a family. It gives you a reason for being. Something to work for.
What is it you're working for?
And all the inhalers you'll ever need.
It's true. The park provides for you whatever your needs are. You provide for it a bit too, I guess.
Well, hold on. Whatever your needs are, as long as your needs are inhalers and abandoned boots.
What else could a man need?
Ugh. The thing I don't like about this game is the game part of it.
Yeah. Do you wish that this was just an ebook?
Kind of.
Oh, someone get on it right now. Search and Rescue Simulation ebooks. SRSR ebooks. Or RSRS ebooks, rather. Someone has to be able to get into this game and just... Oh, man. Yeah. DSH says, I like that Austin is just over here cutting fucking wrestling promos where he's a crazed park ranger so much, you guys. Yeah, that was my backup plan.
Somebody in the chat made a joke about the Wyatt brothers leading us to Zalgo.
I saw that.
I don't know if you're familiar with the Wyatt brothers. They're like a newer wrestling, not newer, I guess, but they've been around for a little bit. But their gimmick is essentially what you're doing.
I know, yeah. They are not my direct inspiration, but someone else pointed me, another friend of mine pointed them out to me earlier this week. I was pretty amazed.
Don't get me wrong, like, I think they're one of the best, most entertaining wrestling groups mm-hmm. going right now just because they have a weird gimmick like that.
Mm-hmm.
More wrestlers
need that
shit. Wait,
so their gimmick is talking slow about ancient evils?
Basically, yeah.
Okay. That's the first thing anyone's ever said about wrestling that's interesting.
We could get Dylan on here. He could say some things.
There's some wrestling has, yeah. I'm
I like the thing I like about wrestling, as with most things, is I like when it's truly and truly natural. Dumb and in a self-aware way.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you guys are I was listening.
Wait. What is this?
What's this, a diary? What does it say? Have spotted a flock of mountain lions grazing. On the hill ahead. This was an echo in his book.
They eat animals.
We'll endeavor to track them to their home. How cool, one of them is looking at me. Oh my, they're all looking at me now. Perhaps I should stop writing this and carefully back away before they run. Professor F. Whiskers, PhD. He actually signed himself off before running away.
That's his first problem. He's dead. He's dead.
All joking aside, you gotta find this dead guy that someone killed. These lions killed.
It was probably the lion. It wasn't. I doubt it was a real person who killed. It was probably the lions.
It was probably the inflatable lions that I blew up and put there before he came.
Don't worry about it. I'm sure it was the mountain lions.
Mm-hmm. And the spike through
a rucksack. Look at those bite marks. What do you mean you can't see them? Look, they're right there. What a sorry state those big cats left this bag in.
Big cats. I realize whenever I say big cats, I throw my arms up in the air, like, big cats, a la, Fuck, what is the Arrested Development character's name? He's the kid who maybe has a crush on?
Oh, Steve Holt.
Steve Holt. I'm doing Steve Holt whenever I say big cats. Thank you.
Other Char says this had better end like Grizzly Man.
Mm-hmm.
We just find a recording of... Oh, man. That's as far as I can go with that joke.
Mm-hmm.
Big cats. No ankles. Just big cats.
Big cats, no ankles.
I wonder if no one's ever talking about how great Arrested Development was.
What?
No one ever brings that up anymore.
What?
I've never even heard anyone else talk about it.
They're all too busy taking their clothes medicine.
I like this bit less than the clothes medicine bit.
Because it's a lie. Because it's just a straight up angry lie.
I'm not mad about it. I love that show. I wish people talked about it more, even though it's all the time.
Why are you mad about it, though?
I'm not mad about it.
I think what I want to focus on is, you know, not whether or not you're mad about it, but let's focus on getting to the heart of why you're mad about it.
Okay.
You know?
Yeah.
As your therapist, I think that's going to be better for us in the long term.
Okay. But you don't think that I should just not be mad at it? You want me to be mad at it, well, but with purpose?
I don't think we need to talk about whether you are or you aren't mad at it. Okay, that's not really the point. The point is, like, why is it that you are so angry about it?
Okay. Phil, can I tell you something?
Yeah.
I'm your therapist.
Hmm.
You have a rare disease where you think that you are the therapist in a therapy session.
Yeah.
When really...
But what if you also have that disease?
I've been treating you for 6 years.
You both have that disease.
I've seen this episode of Home Movies, you guys.
Okay.
Home Movies?
Why... I got nothing. I'm done.
Wait, what's Home Movies?
Have you not seen Home Movies?
What?
No, what's Home Movies?
Is this another really weird bit that you're doing?
No, this isn't a weird bit. I don't know what Home Movies is.
You have to tell me the truth.
Keith, you should watch Home Movies.
Okay.
Get off the stream right now and watch all 4 seasons of Home Movies. I'm disgusted with you.
I've never even heard of it. What is it?
Disgusted with you. I'm disgusted.
I've never heard of it. What is it?
Oh, I can't even with him.
I'm pretty sure that you would like Home Movies a lot.
Is it like America's Funniest Home Videos? Is it like that?
Yeah, like that.
Is it like Candid Camera?
He's not being real.
That's a weird bit, but I really have not heard.
I don't believe you.
Ranger, it seems a vicious bout of amnesia has struck the park. What?
What?
Soltron says Keith is young, you guys. Like,
hold on,
not...
you guys. Our visitors keep forgetting everything. Who are you? Oh, I've got Sheila Turnpike here, and the poor girl can't remember where she pitched her campsite. The girl. Oh, you mean Stephanie. Yes, Stephanie Turnbull here. Can't remember which campsite is hers. Be a dear and find it for her. Come again? Who? But this is Shelley Turnstile. Her campsite should have her sketchbook in it. I saw a campsite near the Needle Monument in the east. So she's camping near the Needle Monument and then forgot everything. And apparently got the form of amnesia that other people can catch as well.
Hold on.
And
she
was sketching the same monument that Sophie was sketching.
Yep.
So she...
Sophie, Shelley...
Soltron notes communicable amnesia.
These girls were camping out near the monument.
I think it's
one girl.
And
they all went to the chief...
It's one girl.
One girl went and she camped out near the chief... near the Needle Monument. She went and told the chief that she got lost. He knows where her thing is, and then he's sending you there alone...
Mm-hmm.
To show her the way?
You have to go back.
I'm just getting her stuff, I think.
Yeah.
It's recovery. This recovery search and rescue simulation. This is the recovery portion of that.
Right. So someone said not to blame me for not seeing the show Home Movies because I'm young. None of them are more than like a few years older than me, and Home Movies, it says that it's a TV show from 1999.
Yeah, well, so, and like, you were born in 2000.
And it ran
I was
for...
born in 2000, so obviously that's why I haven't seen it.
Great.
No, but really, I had never heard of it, and I still don't know.
You should watch it.
You should. I have a feeling that it's the kind of thing you would enjoy.
The first season might be a little rough for you because you hadn't seen it when it was on
really,
originally.
It's still really good, I feel
I
like.
Love it.
Oh,
I love
I've seen these characters. I've seen those characters before.
I just, wait, I want to make sure we're paying attention to all of this mission.
A whatchacallit, soft house. That's it. Is it Samantha Turnkey's?
Samantha Turnkey's soft house?
Uh-huh.
That's one of like a, that's the name of a brothel.
Yeah.
Samantha Turnkey's soft house.
To be clear.
I've been there on nights when I'm lonely. Ooh, a soul capturer. Wait, that's a stupid name. Who are these little people trapped in it? Help them, Ranger. Actually, none of them look like you, Miss Turnheel. Success. This isn't your campsite. We can all go home. No, wait, we've got something to do. Oh, yes, find your campsite. Isn't there one near the block monument? What?
Is he just, like, constantly forgetting shit?
Yeah, that's what this mission is about, dog.
No, but, like, still?
The park has amnesia. It said
you
so.
Only know as much as the park.
Also, it's the kind of amnesia that, like, it's not, like, one time it's, like, constant amnesia over and over again.
What is this game? This is the first, like, super weird thing that they've done in a while.
Yeah, we have had a couple of missions in a row now that have been pretty, like, just kind of, like, go here, find this person. Ah, foot clothes. Are these yours, Miss Turndeep? It's a real
speaks my language.
Keith joke right there. A hair thing. Rather fetching, if I don't say so myself. Stop standing on your head. That's not how humans work, I think. That's what he said.
This happens from time
to time. This isn't amnesia. That's not what this is called. This is something bigger than that.
Soul rot?
Older than that.
Is the technical term?
Soul rot.
The thing is, the campsite, the park, has its own memory. And sometimes it forgets things and needs new memories. Thankfully, there's a hefty supply. Visitors, animals have long memories. Seen a lot. And rangers have the best memories of all. Tasty memories.
Delicious.
Like porridge.
Venora in the chat says, foot clothes, like clothes medicine for feet.
Crocbox says, really, Keith, you get this far in and only now say, what is this game? No, I've been saying that about every 10 minutes for the whole time.
Crocbox says, and now Austin is the narrator from Bastion again.
I changed my pose. Normally my right arm goes over the right side of my chair, and I went left arm over, and I think that's where it threw off.
Yeah.
I have a very
left
specific
arm is definitely
pose
more Logan
character.
Cunningham.
It is.
Also, as we've established, the left arm is more evil and right. Holds more potent magic.
Half sinister.
Sorry, holds more potent magics.
With a CKS.
Yeah.
And a J. Ooh, what is that?
A pocket clock. Excellent find. I might take it for myself. What do you mean it belongs to someone? Oh, yes. Miss Turnyatch. Is it yours? Tiny worms. Hey, where did Miss Turnmop go? She just bolted for the door. Come back.
I guess she doesn't like tiny worms.
But she can't see them from the door.
Look at the shadow of this bird.
The eagles come.
No, so I think the shadow is the real bird. And it's casting itself into the sky.
Where is it leading me? To the monument?
That is the monument.
But what could be there?
So your boss said tiny worms into a radio, and it freaked this girl out so much that she ran,
I have
having
a,
no memory.
I have a sneaking suspicion that's not why she ran.
Or that she ever existed.
What sorcery is this? How does a plastic box produce such fine music? How, I say?
This is an amnesia.
Get down from the ceiling. Like, gravity goes the other way.
This is like the third major instance of amnesia.
That's like
this isn't amnesia, though.
Like,
okay, it's like of he's becoming
the diary of Rupert Trotter. Who's Rupert Trotter?
He's losing his grip on the current time and regressing to his previous iterations.
Is he a friend of yours, Miss Turnstein?
He's going back in time to his ancestors.
Okay.
Keep going, Phil.
That's scary. His ancestors were not so subtle.
Stabby medicine. Would you like a nut misturn joke? You would. Help yourself.
That is
just pick
the
bolts out first.
Keith's medicine. Special medicine, also known as stabby.
Because it's nut allergy medicine.
It just says nut allergy.
Yep.
That's called an EpiPen.
Oh, you should really watch Home Movies. It's a really good EpiPen episode.
What is it?
It's a really good cartoon.
Well, I know it's a cartoon, and I know that from what you're saying that it's good.
It's a cartoon show that's funny. How much, like, what more do you want here?
Like a general plot.
No, I'm not giving it to you. I'll tell you who's behind it, which is the lead producer on Bob's Burgers.
Okay.
And Brendan Small, who does Metalocalypse. It was before he did that.
I've never seen Metalocalypse, but
I think it's better than both of those shows. I like Bob's quite a bit.
Yeah, I would agree. Stark says, wow, I've been using a lot of stabby medicine in Far Cry 3.
Yep. Up here we go.
I think my marbles are returning to me. Lampshades are for lamps, not for hats.
Uh-huh.
Pretty funny.
The only good one was Foot Clothes.
You only think that was good because it was like a continuation of a joke you had made.
No, I just think that's a funny thing to say.
This isn't the first time that the park's lost its memories. Each time it does, it leaves something. Help remember in the future. That's where the monuments came from.
I mean, that makes sense.
Are you saying this park is like living at a giant geographical version of Memento?
He might not
Don't
be saying
trust
that.
John
That's
Key.
What he means.
He lies.
A sketchbook. I remember now. Look at the signature. Stella Turnweed. Excellent stuff, Ranger. Now that this nasty spell of amnesia has worn off.
Spell.
And I guess we'll never find out why it occurred. Call it mass hysteria or the mystery of some omnipotent narrator. But now that it is worn off, I can remember to have words with all those campers for not setting up camp in designated areas.
Have words.
A spell of amnesia. Like, nah, it was just a touch of the forgets.
Ranger, like, did you see that meteor in the sky last night? What do you mean you were busy? Well, then you'll fail to notice that it crashed into the park. I need you to go and track down the impact point to make sure everything is okay and no one got hurt.
You mean you missed something visual in this game?
What do you think are the chances that the impact site of the meteor does not look like anything?
What do you think of the chances that the meteor was actually an inflatable rubber swimming gator?
Yep.
What do you think that as you approach the meteor, it uncurls into a living being?
Okay. It's going to be one of these.
Yep.
Right.
Oh, could you fucking imagine, though, if suddenly this game had, like, Terra Deformation happening, and like there was actually a huge crater and a meteor in the middle of it, and it was smoking. That would be the best.
That's where probably all their
money
went.
It was suddenly an Unreal Engine 4 game.
Yeah, that would be the actual best thing.
But then after this particular mission, it just goes back to the way it was.
Yep.
I need to restart, so I'll be right back, probably.
I'll miss you.
My screen is still freaking out. I don't know
something
why.
Something got into you from the game.
Be careful.
I mean, I'll probably be okay. It's just my computer that's on.
Before you go,
that.
Though,
uh-huh.
Just remember.
Oh, okay.
She wasn't.
I was waiting. I was kind of expecting a no ankles, no dancing joke. Okay, I'll be right back. If I can find where the button is, because it's all dancing. No buttons, no dancing.
Matt Mitchell says, last night equals 1,000 years ago, and the park was created out of the impact.
The crater must be huge, because they give you a big area, right? I mean, they wouldn't give you a space that big to look in unless it was a pretty easy thing to find.
I mean, they gave me this big area, but then there's really tiny red dots in it to look at, so I don't
know. Oh, okay.
Hey guys, I just realized there's no artwork in the Steam community section for this game, which is weird because we have a whole bunch of artwork about this game.
Yeah, we do.
I'm just saying that seems right to me.
Are there any Steam reviews for this? I remember us
none.
Talking about it a little
there was,
bit.
None, yeah.
There were like five, and there were four that were negative, and there was one that was positive, and it was like, I climbed the mountain or something. It's a joke one.
What's this strange gizmo? Is it making a noise, Ranger? Listen. Contact made with Blue Planet Zup. Begin exploration and analysis, Zup. Specimens essential, Zup. Mothership will remain in orbit, Zup, Zup.
What's happening?
Surely just a prank, Ranger.
Surely just a prank.
Bill, how many American dollars did you pay for this game?
I'm pretty sure it was on my press account, so I don't think I paid any. Oh. I can't remember if it was or not. Okay. If it wasn't, it wasn't a lot of money. I think it's only like $20? Maybe?
Crockbox says, Janine, no. That's how they get you. Janine. R.I.P. Janine.
Circle moved. What?
It tends to do that.
Other char says, Zalgo has returned. Go greet him at his point of arrival. Oh, man. I want something primordial to happen in this game, visually.
God, yeah. I do, too. I really want
Just like, if this game ended with the literal awakening of a deep evil.
It would be so good. I mean, I'm prepared to be disappointed, but it would be so good.
Game you would be time. Disappointed?
No, I'm prepared to be disappointed.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Because I fully expect that's not how it will end.
Right.
But I'm going to see it through.
Mm-hmm. At this point, what can you do but?
I love the idea that
Ranger,
are
rings supposed to
this?
Float like that? And look at that jewel. The colors seem to swirl and change at will. Maybe it holds power beyond belief. Maybe we shouldn't touch it.
Okay.
Zup, zup.
I think you should touch the ring.
Touch the ring.
Touch the ring, Phil.
I'm going to reshare so that...
Touch the ring.
Atmid says, Yach, yach, Alan, zup.
Oh, I missed a joke.
Zup, zup.
We found like a radio, and it was basically aliens
music.
Talking about the mothership.
Oh.
Pick it up.
Wow, that's a huge thing to miss.
Wait, it was a ska mothership?
Apparently, that's what we said.
I don't know. I thought that's the Zup Zup thing. I didn't
hear Janine say the thing about the ska, so I think that Ozm just decided to do ska mothership.
We all have our passions.
Mm-hmm. Matt Mitchell says, guys, don't trust this new Janine.
Look, I know I have a scaly tail, Matt. I didn't change who I am on the inside.
But also you're changed on the inside. You have fire for veins.
Yep. Soltron says, no, no, no. Even Alan does not endorse Ska.
Janine's been affected.
Whoa, by look at these tracks, Ranger. Look at these tracks, Ranger. What on earth could make them? I've never seen anything like them in all my months as a park ranger. Wait, I meant years.
Wait, months?
Years as a park ranger. The question is, where's the creature that made these tracks gone?
They literally used those for rabbit tracks, like, a little while ago.
Maybe never it's a deer in high like heels, them. But it's probably a deer.
Nagi says, should we all tweet Zup Zup now?
Oh, God.
Go for it. They'd love it.
Pick it Zup.
Was the Zup Zup thing so that we would know that it's aliens, because otherwise they were just speaking English?
I guess.
Like, are they an alien race that just says Zup sometimes?
I mean, what else are they going to say? Like, hey, P.S., we're aliens.
They already said, like, stay in orbit around the mothership.
Shaded Fox asks, also, like, did Alan...
We don't have a mothership.
Shaded Fox that you know of.
Shaded Fox says, also, did Alan kill everyone's stream or just mine? I want to remind you, Alan doesn't kill, he reclaims.
This stream was once and has always been his.
It has always been Alan, yeah.
Oh god, another weird bracelet thing. What's this? Some kind of bracelet? Look at that weird writing, Ranger. Wait, is it glowing? Don't push any of the buttons, Ranger. It might self-destruct or something.
How does it have buttons?
It doesn't have buttons or writing. Shut up.
It does have writing.
It totally is writing.
It has etching. This chief doesn't know what he's talking about.
Every time I see it, it looks kind of like a plumbing part to me. Like a pipe fitting.
This game is crazy and amazing. I'm a little sick of this guy describing assets.
Same object in eight different ways.
Yeah,
with totally incredulous fucking tones every time. Yeah,
like, this guy's got, like, this same bracelet that had etchings before now has buttons and writing.
They
and it could self-destruct.
Okay. Listen.
They don't have very much.
Like, spend 15 more bucks in the asset store.
Also, I have literally... I cannot think of a single bracelet I've come across in my entire life that ever had buttons.
Well, then it's not... It's an alien thing.
Yeah.
Oh, are you still looking for aliens?
Yeah, they were using
aliens. Like, was done.
No, they were using... Dumb.
It's not going to be done for a long time. I mean, they're here now. We have to learn to live with them.
And just look out and watch the... Look at the planets swaying in the wind.
Wait, so did you find the crash site?
No.
Not yet.
Do you think they're just going to kind of bury that? Like, pretend we didn't say crash site?
Yes.
Like, there was just a ring the whole time.
Right now, I'm just finding weird things that presumably came from the crash site.
Other Char says, the ring simply says, no ankles, no dancing, but in an ancient script.
No wrists, no praising.
Supposed to be something here.
There is something there, you just can't see it.
WorpleFem says, what if the ring was the mothership and the aliens are small?
The belt is on Orion's neck.
Yeah.
What if the bracelet was the mothership and the ring was an escape pod?
Ooh.
You guys are freaking me out right now.
What if the whole thing was a setup to keep you away from the cabin so that the chief could perform ritual murder?
Or non-ritual murder. Just some sort of murder.
Just
Regular boring murder.
Probably two regular murders and then one ritual murder.
Yeah, he likes to mix it up.
Yeah.
What if this is just a whole big setup to weave in some sort of O'Farrell who is like an expert on alien
good
hand
call.
Syndrome?
Thanks.
Matt Mitchell says, big cats, small aliens. Big cats.
Big cat? Big.
That's a dumb joke.
It is.
What? Okay, I think I found something nuts.
Oh, is this the crash site?
Oh, what?
There's, okay.
Hold on.
There is.
That's a new, we found a new prop.
Okay.
I think this could be part of a satellite or maybe a UFO. Kind of just looks like the tail of a plane, though. That's our official report. Plane fragments. Didn't do any damage to the park. Good work, Ranger.
Of course it didn't.
If a plane exploded above your park, that's also a problem.
Yeah, you should report that.
All right. Can I tell you that there's a column on a site called heretical.com called the O'Farrell column that is talking about basically a village, a Jewish village where aliens would come and impregnate women.
Yeah, uh-huh. This is all.
That sounds like a legit theory.
Mm-hmm. It's about an English village in which women are impregnated by a mysterious alien race.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's called the O'Farrell column.
Are they God-fearing Protestant women?
Mm-hmm.
Impregnated by Jewish aliens?
Yeah, I can tell you that the name of the article is Red, White, and Jew.
Oh my god.
Was this made by the dude who made that Blood Dragon DLC?
Aww.
Oh wait, is there something about that dude?
Yeah, don't know. We should watch the first stream. Didn't we talk about this?
I don't know if we talked about it.
I don't remember what stream that was on.
I think we did. That was on. I think that was an Andrew stream.
Oh, you're right.
Last weekend.
That's what it was.
Came up. I think we were talking about when we were playing Garshasp.
Mm-hmm. That dude. I don't know, man. On Polygon.com, there's an interview with him that people stream.
Oh, Polygon.com.
Polygon.com.
People should go to Polygon.com.
Polygon.com.
/run button.
I don't think that's a thing, but I hope it is. I want it to be a thing.
So what should people do once they go to Polygon.com?
I don't know. There's an article.
Just one.
I don't remember the guy's name, so I don't... I'm actually... Austin, do you?
Yeah, Dean Cain. Is that right? Or is that the actor who
plays
Superman?
Yeah, that's the actor, Superman.
Okay.
I think that...
He also hosted Ripley's Believe It or Not.
Right. Dean Evans.
Dean Cain. Got it.
Dean Cain Evans. I was close. It was pretty close.
Guys, I'm pretty sure that website that I was on was a Nazi website.
Yeah, I bet, dog.
It's not. It was also, like the second thing that came out when I Googled O'Farrell and alien.
Also, dude, you're on some fucking FBI list now.
Yeah, have fun with that.
Well, what are they going to do? Like, notice that I don't go to any other Nazi sites?
Only this one?
Well, there's one other, but like, two? Come on.
He's very high standards for Nazi sites, you know? Very picky.
There's one other.
You need to go to at least four or more different Nazi sites to be considered a high-profile threat.
Matt Mitchell says, Herman Cain made Blood Dragon. Yep, Herman Cain. That's right.
Yep.
Herman Cain is Dean Cain's brother.
It's true.
I thought you were going to say Herman Cain is a blood dragon.
That's fair.
No, Dean Cain's the blood dragon, and Herman Cain was always jealous.
Okay.
Okay.
That all adds up.
Yep.
basically math.
And then he killed his brother because he was jealous of him. And that's where we get the myth of Cain and Cain.
Let me ask you guys again. This is just hypothetical. In case, you know, after Keith went to that website, the FBI is listening or anything.
Yeah.
An essay. Have you ever tasted human flesh?
Cooked or uncooked?
I bite my cuticles sometimes.
Either or, Keith, to answer your question.
Okay. Seasoned or unseasoned?
I prefer seasoned.
Yes, by the way.
I mean, seasoned, that doesn't even matter. If you're eating chicken...
You're saying that if I eat human raw versus a nice dry rub, Karind, there's no difference?
Karind or Karined or something is wondering, where does Deckard Cain fit into this whole thing?
Their dad, obviously.
Yeah, he's their dad.
I'm just saying it's not as bad as people make it sound.
There have been circumstances where I've had to eat human flesh, but I've done my best not to taste it at all. You know, I just scarf it down real quick.
Yeah. You just let it slide down your throat, your gullet.
Yep. I mean, sometimes when you're in college, it's either that or ramen, and you've had so much ramen.
I mostly had Chef Boyardee.
We're 4 hours in. Should we stop for tonight?
Wait.
I'm assuming Chef Boyardee doesn't have
we probably should. We've made... Go up. How many missions have we gone through again?
We've done a little, like, 11 or 12.
Okay. That seems fair. Yeah, we started at...
We've taken a sizable chunk out of this.
And the next few look interesting, so... So we'll
Nature
save them
Trail, for that's kind of gross.
The Family.
Night of Free Love. It just ties. You're just gonna go around picking up ties. I'm calling out right now.
Can we see the credits one more time, Phil? I want to write down some names.
Of course.
It definitely didn't say writer anywhere.
It wrote itself.
Someone found the script and
in a church, like an
again.
Old
note
church.
Note that the mission designers and the testing, i.e., QA, same people in a different order. Art has its
one,
one
day
person.
They found this
audio has one
in the
person.
Case where they keep the silent witness.
And that's it. Yeah, Edward Grabowski. All right, I have my list.
All right, we'll be back sometime next week. I'm sure to play more of this because I can't stay away for very long.
Hold on, mission designers? Are you sure?
Yeah, I don't know. We're 4 hours in. I would say at this point we're about half done, maybe a little more. So we've still got a little ways to go, but you know, we're gonna keep recovering. We're gonna keep searching. We're gonna keep rescuing.
Mm-hmm.
We're not gonna sleep.
I can't sleep anymore.
I'll say this: if we even try, then that's when it starts. So.
Yeah. Alan zup zup. Yeah. Alan zup zup. I can't go louder than that. I have roommates. I don't want to wake them up. They shouldn't have to suffer like I suffer.
As a whisper anyway.
Yeah. I found one of the devs on Twitter. The sweary follows him. So that's good.
Done.
Huh.
I just want everyone to remember, no ankles, no dancing. Have a great weekend. My name is Phil Kohler. If you're watching this live and you'd like to catch up on archives, you can go to youtube.com/Kefkatarin. If you're watching this on YouTube and you'd like to join us live, we're at twitch.tv/Kefkatarin. We got some stuff coming up on YouTube. I don't know. What is... I think the end of Crypt Worlds goes up this weekend.
Ooh.
So if you never caught Crypt Worlds, you'll be able to watch all of it on the archives as of... on YouTube, that is, as of this weekend. And I think... Next week, we have some other stuff coming, including a bunch of, like, Don't Starve, and maybe some Payday 2 also. So you have that to look forward to. Where are you guys at on the internet?
You can find me on Twitter at Austin_Walker, on Twitch at TheCalculTech, and at ClockworkWorlds.com.
And you can find me at Bleating Heart. on Twitch and Twitter and YouTube. And I got some Sailor Moon videos on YouTube. Those are probably worth checking out if you're not quite ready to go to bed yet. Yeah. They're popping.
You can find me on... We're not done? Are you done?
No.
I was waiting for you, yeah.
Okay, I was waiting to make sure you were done. You can follow me on Twitter at something dumb. You can follow my cousin Kyle and I. We do Let's Plays. You can go to our YouTube page by going to runbutton.net. We're doing all of the Mario games right now. We just started a Let's Play of Sonic Lost World today. You can follow me on Twitch at twitch.tv/somethingdumb, but with no G in it.
Awesome. That's all of us.
Does you go?
I went second.
I wasn't paying attention.
Shut it off.
My name is Austin Walker. You can find me on Twitter at Austin_Walker. Find me on Twitch at TheCalcuTech, and you can find me at ClockworkWorlds.com. What about you, Janine?
What? Why are we doing this again?
You can find me on Twitter at SomethingDumb.
Okay.
You can go to my YouTube page where I do Let's Plays at runbutton.net. Or you can go to my my Twitch page, twitch.tv/somethingdumb.
Cool. Phil, what about you? Where can I find you?
It's just watching. It's silent. It's a silent
witness. /polytheism.com, says Matt Mitchell. That's where you can find Phil.
It's just a silent witness.
Crybox says, is The Lost World a video up today or just recorded it today? No, it's up today.
It's up. It was good.
I watched a brand new thing. Thank you.
My favorite thing about your videos right now is how much he, being Kyle, is excited to go back to Sonic and how much you fucking hate it. And you don't even hide it, even a little bit.
I said it was my first thing that I said was that I was not excited. It's fine.
No ankles, no damage.